one.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to Christy Mathewson Field here on the campus of Keystone College for a rarity for us to be saying here, Game 3, winner take all for this CSEC semifinal game between St. Elizabeth and Keystone College. Ladies and gentlemen, in your duo is back together, Mr. Colin Franco, JT Colapietro, checking in with you guys. Mr. Colin Franco, how are we, sir?
How are we doing? Good to see you.
I'm fantastic, man. And yeah. I don't know how much more you want me to break it down for you. Who winner take all game 3. Giants win, they stay here. Wilson comes up here. Here St. Elizabeth wins. St. Elizabeth travels down to Wilson. Nonetheless, we can all guarantee one thing. A date with Wilson is on the line.
Yeah, it's very rare, as you mentioned before, a game 3, which is a winner takes all. Winner heads to the CSEC championship. Either Keystone is hosting or St. Elizabeth will be traveling down to Wilson. I don't remember the last time that Keystone has played a game 3 in regards to a semifinal, but you know this series has been very interesting to say the least. In game 1 you saw more of a pitcher's duel, a defensive battle in game 1, while game 2 you saw more of an offensive explosion. Game 3 is pretty much going to be a hit or miss, to be honest. So it's going to be really interesting to see what's going to go down this afternoon.
Absolutely. And you talk about game two, game one. Game one, you saw Nate Hinckley of the Giants doing his thing, going out there, 92 pitches, isn't everything like that. 2-1 finish, as you said. And then a 15-8 game two, where you saw St. Elizabeth hit 4 home runs in that game.
Yeah, it was the fourth inning when Hamilton had that home run to right center, which hit a bus. Yes, you heard that right. He hit the team bus, and then you had 2 home runs by Piper, say one coming in the seventh, which was a 3-run homer, and then a solo home run in the ninth, and then Drew Zimmerman with a grand slam in the second game. So, if St. Elizabeth bats could get hot as they were in game two, this could get really interesting, to say the least. And Keystone's just going to settle down St. Elizabeth's bats. So,
and the other thing to keep in mind in terms of the starting lineups, only thing that's really changed for both teams in terms of their starting lineups, virtually the same. The only two things, as I said before, that are starting to change, starting pitchers, Pat Adamski for the Giants, and then you go ahead, you get Aiden Patella of St. Elizabeth. So it's going to be interesting. Going to turn it over to our public address. Address announcer John Franquez for the starting lineups.
And welcome to Christy Mathewson Field on the campus of Keystone College for today's third semifinal game between the St. Elizabeth Eagles and your own Keystone College Giants. And now, without any further ado, let's meet the starting lineups, beginning with the Eagles. Leading off and playing right field, number 4, Joe Braun. Batting second and playing second base, number 14, Justin Ortero. Batting third and playing center field, number 22, Jake Piperczyk. Batting fourth and playing first base, number 8, Josh Kohler. Batting fifth and playing left field, number 11, Brad Edwards. Batting sixth and playing third base, number 28, Paul Hamilton. Batting seventh, designated hitter, number 35, Drew Zimmerman. Batting eighth, the catcher, number 13, Angelo Marabello. Batting ninth, the shortstop, number 12, Jack Tone. And pitching today for the Eagles, number 29, Aiden Patella. Head coach, Arlen Freeman. And now, the starting lineup for your Keystone College Giants. Leading off and playing second base, number 20, J.D. Barrett. Batting second, the designated hitter, number 10, Julio Acosta. Batting third and catching, number 22, R.J. Goldsberry. Batting fourth and playing right field, number 7, Vince Montone. Batting fifth and playing left field, number 31, Adam Kelly. Batting sixth and playing third base, number 14, Chris Hatsaw. Batting seventh and playing first base, number 30, Pedro Abreu. Batting eighth and playing shortstop, number 1, Bobby Picordi. and batting ninth and playing center field number 5, Jason Thomas. Pitching today for the Giants, number 33, Pat Adamski. The Giants are coached by Mr. Jamie Shevchak. And now, if everyone would please rise and remove your caps and join us in honoring America and those who proudly serve her with the playing of our national anthem.
Phoenix. A day with the Wilson Phoenix. Phoenix is on the line next. First pitch when we return. Ladies and gentlemen, first pitch just about to get started.
Leading off the first for the Eagles will be their right fielder, number 4, Joe Braun.
As you can have Joe Braun dig into the dish. It's to start game one. A combined 2-for-8 yesterday for Mr. Braun. Braun, however, does not mean he was not a very heavy contributor for the St. Elizabeth Eagles yesterday. Hey, Braun.
Yeah.
throwing a 324 hitter for the St. Elizabeth Eagles. His first pitch shows bunt, but he's going to pull back and take first pitch strike, and we are underway from Christy Mathewson Field here.
As I mentioned before, Joe Braun batting 324 has appeared in 23 games with 19 starts, with 4 home runs, 18 RBIs, has 22 hits on the year, which include 4 doubles and 2 triples.
As that last pitch was fouled off Adamski, looking for a little bit of a put-away pitch as Adamski comes set, deals. That ball is cut onto left field. Hold Adam Kelly going back at the track, at the wall, it is gone! First batter of the game, aim for the St. Elizabeth Eagles, goes yard. What a start if you are St. Elizabeth.
You couldn't think of a better start for St. Elizabeth right now.
Now batting the second baseman.
It's a fastball that was just right down the middle. Absolutely crushed it to left center, just around where the College World Series is on the back. What a start for St. Elizabeth in game 3.
Absolutely. As you're going to have Justin Otero dig in for Phoenix, or for the Eagles of St. Elizabeth. That's the first, as next pitch from Pat. A little bit outside right there. Her first pitch, ball.
Otero in game 1 went 0 for 3. In game 2,
3 for 5.
So a much better game 2.
His next pitch is going to be just missing right there. Adamski trying to find the strike zone. Oh, being a little bit cautious here after that first batter home run. And next pitch. Popped in the air. That's by the first base bag. Pedro Abreu for the Giants makes the play. One away.
Yeah, the big thing for Adamski here right now is he has to bounce back after giving up that leadoff home run. That's a good start with the fly out in foul territory to Abreu.
Absolutely. And the one thing... Absolutely, as obviously you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna get Perverick, who huge contributor yesterday for the Eagles.
Yeah, Jacob Pipersick, the center fielder, junior out of Lakewood Ranch, Florida, who had 2 home runs in game 2, a 3-run shot in the 7th, and a solo home run in the 9th that was mentioned during our pregame show. He's looking to build off of that game 2 performance.
His first pitch cut on and missed a little bit of a slider cutter right there from Adamski.
Hypersick also a first-team All-CSAC. It was the only Eagle named to the first-team All-CSAC. Otero, who was the second hitter, the second batter, I should say, he was a second-team All-CSAC.
3 for 6, as we said, with 4 RBIs for Pipersick, as next pitch is going to be taken for a ball. Looked good, but... But home plate umpire has other words on that one. But nonetheless, like I said, 3 for 6 in game 2 yesterday, that 15-8 final, and then an 0 for 3 as well. Well, his next pitch from Adamski is going to be popped in the air once again. Second baseman J.D. Barrett underneath it makes the catch. Just like that, 2 away. And this is exactly the bounce back you want to see from Adamski after giving that up that leadoff home run.
You're
going to have Josh Kohler digging for the Eagles now. Oh, so definitely a positive to see right now if you are the Giants.
Kohler 2 for 4 in game 1. And in game 2, he was also the starting pitcher and then was moved to DH. He was 1 for 4. He also contributed 2 RBI in the second game.
Yeah, definitely helping himself out as first pitch is going to be a ball. All from Adamski. And Adamski working quickly, going right back to the second pitch. Next pitch. It's going to get by RJ. A little bit of a skip slider right there. Kohler on the season, one of the main contributors for the St. Elizabeth offense's next pitch. Gonna be popped in the air once again. Right fielder Vince Montone underneath it, and just like that, at Adamski after the leadoff home run. Gets three quick outs. Well, not much more you can ask for.
Yeah, great job by Adamski to bounce back after that leadoff home run. And here's the thing with pitchers, too. Usually when they get off a leadoff home run, their emotions kind of get the best of them. You know, their performance on the mound may not be as what they were. Able to bounce back after giving up that leadoff home run.
Absolutely. And like we said, Eagles up 1-0 going into the bottom of the first. Giants coming to bat.
I didn't realize that was you.
What's going on?
Not much.
One coming back at you, ladies and gentlemen, from Christy Mathewson Field. As you see, he's a starter for four. Or Wilson and Patella going ahead, throwing his last warm up. As you're gonna get J.D. Barrett, excuse me, leading off for the Giants here. We're in the bottom of the first. First, and J.D. Barrett be getting very comfortable with that leadoff spot as of late for the Giants.
Yeah, Barrett. Yeah, Barrett has so far. He's a transfer out of Cabrini University. Had been very productive in his senior season with the Giants on the 2022 season, batting .305 in 38 appearances.
This is going to go ahead and chop that over to first base. A little bit of miscommunication right there, but first baseman is going to go ahead and take that over himself. And you're going to go ahead and get a 3-U on that one. One is Julio Acosta. Just like that, Giants jumping on the first pitch. And now you got Julio Acosta coming up to the dish now.
Little stats on Patella, 6.89 ERA, 1-5 record, 11 appearances with 5 starts. Struck out 19 batters against 14 walks. Has pitched 32.2 innings this season.
The Giants are just jumping over the first pitch. Julio grinds out to shortstop right there. 6-3 on the putout. You get 3, 4, and 5, and now coming up, RJ Goolsberry. You would have to assume probably going to be taking the first pitch, but it's good. You wouldn't be mad if you went ahead, took a first pitch swing. And as we said, Sean Murphy Award winner, RJ Goolsberry, and CSAC Player of the Year.
I was just going to mention that CSAC Player of the Year. Goolsberry had himself a tremendous season this year.
It's perfect. It's working quickly. He first pitched low to RJ.
331 batting average, 11 home runs, 48 RBIs.
As next pitch is going to be a strike. Right to RJ. And RJ, again, one of the main contributors for this Giants team, 1-for-4 yesterday, and a combined 3-for-7. And as pitch is going to go ahead, that's going to miss. It's going to be a 2-1 count for RJ. He's got Vince Montone on deck. Next pitch from Pippert. It's going to be ripped to left field. That ball's high. It is going to be fair. And down the line, RJ hustling for two. He is going to be in there with a stand-up double. And just like that, after two quick outs, RJ goes ahead. It gets on base. You bring up Vince Montone now coming up for the Giants.
A great piece of hitting by Goolsberry down the left field line. Able to be an extra base hit, able to get himself into scoring position. Montone looking to either advance Goolsberry to third or potentially bring him home depending on what happens.
Montone 2-for-7 yesterday in the series. He's in Montone. Cologne, another returner for the Giants coming back. Definitely no stranger to this situation. In as Piprick is going to go ahead, come set, first pitch. Yes. That is going to be swung on, hit to left field. Well, left fielder, or underneath it, makes the catch. Catch Edwards Jr. for making the catch right there. And just like that, Giants. Hints, not able to capitalize, but they are hitting pretty well. Score is 1-0 as we go both to the second. Top two coming at you from Christy Matthews and Field. As you're going to go ahead, you're going to have Brad Edwards lead off for the Eagles, who just made that final put out in left field to end the bottom of the first. Edward, a 322 hitter on the season so far. All right, now.
Edwards was 2-for-4 in game one. He also pitched in relief in game one, went 6 innings, gave up 4 hits with 3 walks and a strikeout.
This is going to go ahead and pop that one up. Abreu giving it a look and just going to let that one foul. 0-1 on the start of the game. Edwards also in game two, though, 1-for-5. 5 out of Edwards, however, at the same time, he was extremely productive, as you said. One of the rare play, something you rarely see nowadays, pitcher coming in from the outfield to pitch and everything like that. And obviously, huge contributor.
Yeah, two-way position players. St. Elizabeth has a couple of those guys on the team. Keystone does as well.
He's going to go ahead and fire that one. Sorry for cutting you off, but he's going to go ahead and fire that one in there for a strike. But as you were saying, good sir.
That was a ball.
Or for a ball, my apologies. Dancing next pitch, curveball is going to go ahead. That's going to hit Edwards. Just like that, we're on first base for St. Elizabeth once again. And that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Hamilton.
Yeah, Hamilton had that big home run. As mentioned in the pregame show, that big home run to right center that hit off the St. Elizabeth team bus.
Hamilton 0-for-4 in game one, but then went ahead and went 2-for-3, as you said, with that home run in game two. Hamilton, first pitch. Slider, just going to miss outside on that one.
Hamilton batting .292 on the year, has started in 26 games, has 5 home runs and 21 RBIs on the season.
As the 1-0 from Adamski comes set, deals. That's going to be dribbled on the ground, second base. He's over to second. That's going to go ahead. That's going to be a 4-6-3. He double play. Looked a little bit slow on the grounder and everything like that. Didn't think it was going to be a double play, but never give up on the Giants and everything like that. Able to turn that double play.
Yeah, as you mentioned before, that was a very slow ground ball. I expected Barrett just to throw to first to get Hamilton out, but they were able to turn the double play to get Edwards out. Big double play for the Giants defense.
Very good heads-up defense by J.D. Barrett on that one, as Zimmerman's going to go ahead. He's going to dig in.
Zimmerman had the grand slam in game two, and one of the few seniors on this St. Elizabeth squad.
And St. Elizabeth, And as you said before, St. Elizabeth, a very young core. As Zimmerman was also second team. He for CSAC says first pitch is going to go ahead in the dirt right there. First slider for Adamski as he's going to go ahead. He's going to fall behind 2-0. 2-0 to Zimmerman. Adamski working quickly. Here's the 2-0. That ball's going to be fouled back. That kid off the road, going to the creek a little bit. Yeah, Zimmerman, as you said yesterday, 2-for-4 with that grand slam in the fifth inning. Being as well as 0-for-1.
Yeah, that grand slam ultimately changed the momentum of this game.
Absolutely.
In game two.
As J.D. Barrett's going to get another play over at second base. On to first, makes the play, and just like that, we are out of the top of the second, bottom second. How about we go there, good sir? Two coming back at you from Christy Mathewson Field as you're going to have number 31, Adam Kelly, who batting 531 in the CSAC on the season. In and Kelly started off the season in a little bit injured, but what a spark plug he has been coming back for the Giants.
Ever since Kelly came back, he's provided that spark for the Giants offense, has been stellar since his return. Thing to note that he hit 4 home runs against Clarkson, which I believe is a program record for most home runs hit in a game.
It is hit, and right on cue, that ball is hit deep to left field. Left fielder just turns, waves it goodbye. Bye.
Come on.
Bye. A solo shot for Adam Kelly, right on cue. As we are now tied at 1.
You couldn't have timed that more perfectly, JT.
You could not have. Leads the team in home runs. You need a spark plug. There you go. 1-1 Giants. And just like that, oh, this game is starting off good, sir. As Chris Hatzel is going to go ahead and dig in into the dish now. Over the Giants.
Hatzel also has been a stellar for the offense as well, batting 348 on the year, has 4 home runs, 32 RBIs, a all-CSAC first-team selection, and a local product as well from Lehman, Pennsylvania, out of Lake Lehman High School.
This Hatzel is going to go ahead and take a little bit of a cutter for inside right there. As next pitch is going to go ahead, just missed low on that one. And right now, oh, Hatzel digging in right now. Oh, a little bit more confident than usual. What was the next pitch? Fastball right down the middle. Or for a strike for Hatzel. Oh, as you got Pedro Abreu on deck for the Giants. Hatzel, as you said before, they're doing very well for the Giants, batting 420 in the CSAC and everything like that. And again, and as that's going to go ahead, that's going to be ripped in the right center field. That's going to find the gap. That'll get to the wall. Hatzel digging for second. He's going to get in there with a stand-up double. And just like that, Giants got something cooking here in the bottom of the second inning as Pedro Abreu going to go ahead and dig in.
I think the middle of the heading to the bottom of the order, they started to kind of figure out Patella's pitches. We start to make some contact, get some base hits. Good start for the inning so far for the Giants.
Absolutely, as you said. Ted, you're going to go ahead and get Pedro Abreu, who, what a story it's been for him as well. Talk about injuries.
Yeah, was injured late going into last season, suffered a season-ending injury, wanted to come back after missing a bulk of the end of the last season, and this season has been very productive in 30 game appearances with 26 starts, batting .318 on the season.
That's first pitch slider is going to go ahead and miss outside right on that one. And as you said, .318 for Abreu, who won the year, and what a story. He was also named CSAC Honorable Mention team, as that's going to be it. Go ahead, that's going to be ripped into center field. Oh, that's going to be a single. Oh, as Hatzel's going to be held up at third. But Giants got something cooking here. Very well. Oh, Bobby McCourney coming up. Up, oh, runners on the corners. And the Giants, you know how they like to play.
McCourney.
Hey, so you can see something in the works here. As I said, Bobby McCourney, who started off hot for the Giants and honestly has kept that way for him.
Batting .315 on the year, has 3 home runs and 24 RBIs.
Absolutely.
In 36 games in which he has started.
Absolutely. Yes. Pickoff is going to go ahead and go over to first base. It's handled by the first baseman, but not too crazy. Nothing too crazy to get away. Hey, but nonetheless, yes, you got runners on the corners. No outs here for Bobby. There's another pickoff attempt. Attempt over at first base. Ace, obviously, as I said before, Pepperidge obviously thinking there's going to be something going on.
I think he's worried about the potential steal. Maybe if Abreu is sent by the first base coach, and they probably send Hatzel home.
It's going to be grounded through the left side. That's going to be a base hit. Hatzel will score. Abreu is going to be held up at second base. And just like that, Giants are now ahead 2-1 in the second inning here. As you're going to get the bottom home of the order, Jason Thomas coming up to bat. And the one thing you can always count on with JT Thomas, it's inarguably from a lot of people. Well, if you listen to a lot of people, probably one of your fastest center fielders in the lineup.
Yeah, Thomas has some speed, and that's why he's out there in the outfield. Also on the base pass, so he could be a threat for stealing bases. He's stolen 14 bases this season, which actually leads the team.
This first pitch is going to be bunted. A little bit of small ball for the Giants. However, that's going to go ahead. That will work out. But as you got the sacrifice bunt, though, moves those runners over. One of what? Hey, now, and you go back to the top of the order. Exactly what you want from Jason Thomas is you got J.D. Barrett now coming up to bat.
Yeah, the Patel ended up feeling the bunt. He got Thomas by, I think, a step or two. He almost beat it out. I think if he just had a little bit more speed, but Thomas did a job, was able to advance Abreu and Picorni into scoring position. So Barrett knows what he has to do now.
And again, that's nothing more. And again, that's something you can't ask much more from your nine hitter. J.D. Barrett's going to go in. That's going to be ripped to right field. Hold Abreu. Will score. That's going to get to the wall. Picorni will score. J.D. Barrett pulls up to second with an RBI double. And just like that, the Giants have busted it open with a 4 spot here in the second inning so far. And something to keep in mind. Only one out here with Julio Acosta coming up.
Here we go, Julio Acosta.
Let's go, Julio.
Keep it going, baby. Come on. It's getting crowded in that dugout, huh?
Acosta with a 6-3. He ground out on that one to shortstop in his first at bat. As I said, that was a bases clearing double for J.D. Barrett. His first pitch can just miss. Is he going to go ahead? It's St. Elizabeth sending some guys down to the bullpen and start throwing.
Here we go, guys. Come on.
You kind of hear this Giants crowd also coming alive a little bit. Hit the 1-0. It's going to miss just outside to Julio.
I like those cards.
The other thing again to keep in mind, Giants smell blood. But as 2-0 from Pepperidge,
here we go,
it's
going to
step
on,
off real quick. But going to now come set. It checks on JD twice. The pitch. Yeah, it's going to be fouled back over into the creek.
Thing to know about Acosta, too, he's an all honorable mention, all CSAC. A thing to note this year. Acosta is mainly a catcher. However, he's actually started a couple games in left field this season.
And as you
when I first saw that, I was like, okay, he could play in the outfield and catch.
Pat Perez is going to go ahead and take a step off there. And that's something that you want to have always. And for a catcher, that's a very good thing to do. Who transfer not only to from behind the dish to the outfield, but you get a fantastic arm behind the dish. That's going to be a wild pitch. Go over to, and J.D. Barrett's going to go ahead. He's going to advance to second on, over to third on that one. Excuse me. And now Giants really got something cooking here. 3-1 count. One out, runner on third. And it doesn't get much easier from this because after Acosta, you got 3, 4, and 5. You got RJ, you got Montone, and you got Adam Kelly, who actually already homered this inning.
They potentially bat around pending the outcome of these at-bats.
That's the 3-1. That's going to miss in the dirt. J.D. Barrett's going to be coming home on this one. J.D. slides. He is in there. And just like that, two wild pitches come in. 5-1 Giants. Wild pitch.
Now batting.
Wild pitch.
The catcher, number 22, RJ Hoosberg.
And just like that, again, you got the 3-4-5 coming up. Up and something to keep in mind. A lot of people forget about this about Julio because he is a catcher. Julio's got some speed on him.
Yes, he does.
And again, a lot of people forget that because he's a catcher.
13 stolen bases on the season.
Second most on the team and everything as RJ is going to go ahead. First pitch upstairs with a fastball. Patella starting to lose the zone a little bit right here.
I think the second inning, I think after that leadoff home run from Kelly, he hasn't been the same since.
So RJ's going to take a curveball. Down below, right around the knees. But the thing to keep in mind with RJ, hey, at the same time, got to see a first pitch strike. Like, you give up a walk and everything like that, you got to hear strike one. That's golden rule. As RJ's going to go ahead and chase that one real quick, and he knew it.
Goldsberry doubled down the left field line in his first at bat.
Yeah, RJ, and you know that if RJ goes ahead, he gets all of another double, Julio could easily score first at home. That's the 1-2. That's going to be poked in the center field. Deepest part of the yard. Center field is there, though. Julio retreats back to second base. He's a little bit of a cat and mouse game. And just like that, two away here for the Giants, but you got Vince Montone coming up. The cleanup hitter for the Giants. Yeah, Pepperick, who made that catch out there in center field.
Maybe we should keep you up at night before the game so you can tire.
First pitch to Montone is going to be right at the knee, skull for a strike.
No, you're good, man. You're good, baby. Come on, Lachie, let's go.
Montone had a very hard hit fly out to left field to start off the game.
Almost.
Patella checks on Acosta at first.
Patella with a little bit of a quick off move right there. Didn't even come set with that one. Kind of just stepped off, threw over. They're trying to catch Julio sleeping. Julio, though, wide awake. Hey, Kez Montone's going to go ahead. Next pitch in there for a strike, and it is now 0-2 to Montone.
Patella's hoping to get an out from Montone, whether it's a strikeout, ground out, or whatever. Because he does not want to face Kelly again after what he did to him at the beginning of the inning.
Oh, absolutely. About a mere 20 minutes ago. Just about 15, 20 minutes ago. And the thing to keep in mind, right again with this Giants team, each ball that they've flown out, very well hit. Montone's going to rip that one back up the middle. That's going to be a base hit. Julio's going to stay put at second base. And in a way, St. Elizabeth's was playing a little bit of shift there. As said this before in this inning, Adam Kelly coming up to bat. Who's already homered in this inning.
Keep you up at night. Here you go, Kelly. Come on.
Adam Kelly, I believe he jumped on that first.
It was the first. It was on the first pitch. That ball went by.
That soared over the over the netting in left field. This first pitch, Kelly's gonna go ahead and take that one. In the dirt. Julio's gonna go ahead and advance over to third base. Ace, along with Montone, a little bit of a passed ball right there. But a great job nonetheless. As behind the dish is four for Mirabella. Mirabella doing a great job blocking that. But this is something you do not want. Adam Kelly up as he's going to go ahead and chase a slider. Got a little bit fooled on that one. One is it's 1-1. Giants got to stay calm a little bit. That was a beautiful slider, by the way, though. Oh, not discrediting in that pitch. But again, this is something you do not want if you're a Patella. Kelly, who's already homered on you, now has runners on second and third. Next pitch. That's going to be chopped up the middle. What a stop over at second base. Aces, that's going to go ahead. That'll score two. That'll score two. Ooh, but the second baseman, Otero. What an attempt to just get to that.
Yeah, great attempt by Otero, but unfortunately the throw did get away from the first baseman, Kohler, that was able to bring home. Well, Acosta was going to score without a doubt, but then Montone was able to score from second. So great job from Otero, though, to make sure that ball didn't get in the outfield.
Extremely great heads-up base running there by Montone to realize that play was still alive. Nobody called. Well, and the beautiful thing about baseball is Hatzel's going to go ahead chase first pitch slider in the dirt. Giants starting to like that first pitch slider. 7-1 Giants, by the way. But the thing to keep in mind, and the one thing you got to love about this Giants team, even the one thing you got to love about baseball, no whistles in baseball. Play was still alive, because that's going to be grounded over to shortstop. Flips on the second, and just like that, we are out of the inning. But 7 runs come across this second inning. And just like that, 7-1 Giants going into the top of the third. And what a game it's been.
Nice and long one today, baby. Oh, let's go, DB! He's back!
We missed him yesterday.
Here you go, Julio, baby. I see you. I see you, kid. Here you go, 3-3. Here you go. Lock in, baby. Come on. Another good inning. Come on. Here you go, Pat. Come on, baby.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Christy Mathewson Field as 7-1 as we head to the top of the third, as I said before. And you're going to go ahead, you're going to have the catcher, Mirabella, go ahead, dig in for St. Elizabeth.
Mirabella, an honorable mention, all CSAC this season. With a 2.42 ERA, 22 games started with 15 hits on the season.
Mirabella going to go ahead. And first pitch chopped out of third. Hatzel on the first. Just like that. Went away. Adamski. And as you're going to go ahead, you're going to have Jack Tone digging in the shortstop. Who had a pretty good play as well to end the bottom of the second. But that is a great sign if you are the Giants right there, seeing Adamski get that first pitch out. You love to see that, especially after a 7-run inning.
Jack Tone went 1-for-4 in game one against the Giants, and game two was a lot better, 3-for-5.
As that's going to go ahead, that's going to be chopped over to first base. Pedro, where are you calling off Adamski? He steps over to first base, and just like that, Brayu, and just like that again. This is what you like to see after a 7-run second inning. You love to see your pitcher going ahead, getting back into the groove, and as we go back to the top of the order, Braun going to go ahead, he's going to dig in. Joe Braun, a junior out of Somerville, New Jersey.
Also had that leadoff home run for St. Elizabeth to start off the game.
Yeah, you would
the only hit so far for St. Elizabeth.
As first pitch is going to go ahead, a little bit of a cutter right there. Adamski, that's been a pitch that he's been working on over his career here over at Keystone. And so definitely developing today, as next pitch is going to be high. High fastball right there.
Here you go, 3-3, come on, kid.
As you said before, Mr. Franco. Oh, Brong hitting that leadoff home run. As Brong now showing bunt. He will go at home plate umpire is going to go ahead, give him the signal, say he did check. He did go ahead and make the attempt on that one.
Yeah, I get why Brong wanted to bunt, because I think he just wanted to try to get on base by any means, try to fool the infield a little bit since they're kind of playing a little bit back. But he ended up going, so it's going to be strike two.
That's a 1-2. It's going to be bounced. Adamski trying to get him to chase a little bit, but Brong showing great discipline right there.
Come on, keep it going.
Yeah, no, that's something you can't necessarily do it. Ooh, in the infield, obviously, if you got a 1-1 count going in and everything like that, you play back. Heck, leadoff hitters will try and just do something to sort of spark for you. As Adamski's 2-2, it's going to be fouled off. Oh, Brong doing a great job staying alive here. Brong scored 2 runs in game. In 2 yesterday for St. Elizabeth. It was, as I said before, going 2 for 4 in game 1. As the 2-2 is going to be fouled off once again. And right now, Brong, this is something. Down 7-1, something like this, a quick at-bat, or a at-bat where you're battling. This will do so much for confidence and everything. And as Adamski is going to go ahead, come set, and deal. That is going to be put on the ground. First base, Abreu. Great job knocking that down. Flips over to Adamski, and that's going to go ahead. And that's going to go ahead, and Brong's going to reach on that one.
Here you go, DT. You good, baby. Keep your head. Keep your head.
That's Abreu. Second base. Going to go ahead.
Number 14, Justin Ochoa.
Abreu, again, great job to get it there, but unfortunately, took too long to develop and everything like that. And so, keeps the inning. Inning alive for Otero now. Oh, and again, if you're St. Elizabeth, that is a great way to keep this inning alive. I have to be honest with you, as the first pitch from Adamski is going to miss just high.
Yeah.
Here we go, Pat. Here we go. We're good, baby. We're good.
Otero, well, starting second baseman for St. Elizabeth, that's going to go ahead and be fouled off. Justin Otero from the Bronx, New York. Kirk, another junior for the St. Elizabeth squad. And as I said before, something positive for the St. Elizabeth 15. This is a young squad coming in here. It's Chrissy Mathewson.
Yeah, St. Elizabeth is only a third-year program, and most of their lineup, probably their first year, was a lot of underclassmen. They just were able to get in some transfers just to add some experience and just some veteran leadership to the program. But over the past couple of years, they've developed nicely over the 3 years that this program has existed. And this is their first appearance in the CSAC playoffs.
As that's going to go ahead, that's going to be hit in the air, left field. Well, Kelly's going to play that on a hop. Up, as that's going to be thrown down to second base. He's so. Oh, just like that, Otero goes ahead and gets a double on that one. And as Kelly had to play that on the hop. Popping just like that, St. Elizabeth. If Peverage coming up right now, oh, he's got to go ahead. Number 3 hitter, this is something you would like to see, especially after giving up a 7-1 inning.
Piper-Sick popped up to second base in his first at bat as he looks to bring home potentially one, maybe two, depending on what happens here.
Absolutely, and the other thing to keep in mind, 2 outs though, so you got to get it in play. Zdanski's first pitch going to be popped in the air. J.D. Barrett camping underneath it. J.D. Barrett's going to make the play, and Zdanski tight ropes out of danger. Her S score is going to go ahead. It's going to remain 7-1. The Eagles trying to show some life here.
2.5 innings in the book with your score remaining. The Giants 7, the Eagles 1.
Oh, my God, DB. There it is, kid. There it is. We missed you yesterday. Here we go, buddy. Here we go.
Oh, there's a watermelon. Yeah.
Bottom three coming at you, ladies and gentlemen, from Christy Mathewson Field, as Perella going to be staying out there for St. Elizabeth. But you got a couple of people out in the St. Elizabeth bullpen and everything, as you're going to get Pedro Abreu as well, leading off for the Giants.
Number 30, Pedro Abreu.
Abreu one for one so far with that single, which advanced Hats to the third. And kind of got this party, they got that party going around in the second inning. Giants trying to capitalize on that. This first pitch, it's going to go ahead. That's actually going to be a curveball that stays in and hits Pedro. Oh, and controversial way they start off the inning. But nonetheless, you got Bobby Corny now coming up with Pedro on first.
Batting the shortstop.
Yeah, the question is St. Elizabeth going to potentially warm up a pitcher? Because we're only 2.5 innings into this game, and I know that it's very rare to see a pitcher get warm. I know they want to kind of rest some of their arms, since a lot of them had to do a lot of work in the first two games. So we'll see what happens with St. Elizabeth now, as the leadoff hitter this inning, Abreu, reached base.
As Picorni's going to go ahead, rip that one back up the middle. Oh, what a stop by Otero at second base. On the first, that's going to go ahead. And that is going to get Picorni. Either Speedy Picorni gets out at second base. And what a play to start off with Otero over at second base.
That was some elite defense by Otero. I'm not sure if you saw it. He literally dove through the ball behind his back to the shortstop Tone. On the first to Kohler. 4-6-3 double play.
Absolutely.
Could have asked for some pitcher perfect defense.
Absolutely. As you have Jason
from the St. Louis second defense.
Absolutely. As you got Jason Thomas digging in as the first pitch. Be taken for a strike at the knees. He's in. The other thing to keep in mind, that St. Elizabeth has been doing a lot that I've been noticing. Playing a little bit of a shift when you get a runner on first base, which right there, they were playing a little bit of a shift for Bobby. And worked out to perfection.
Here you go, JT, come on.
And you have to realize in a way, if Otero's just a little bit over, potentially seeing as the next pitch. Gonna be low. Count most of 2-1 here. But as I said before, Volterra's a little bit more or towards the right side. Right, that might get through and you might get a little bit of trouble. But again, great defense by Otero. Stops that one. It's the 2-1. It's gonna be hit on the ground. Third base, that's gonna be fouled off.
Here you go, JT. Lock it. You good?
Patella right now at 36 pitches. Is working right now over the 2-1 count, so about 40 pitches right now. It's going to be chopped on the ground, third base. He makes the play, and that is going to go ahead, be thrown on the first, and just like that, something him Patella needed, a 1-2-3 inning to get out of the third. Let's go to the fourth. It's good, sir. What do you say?
There you go, DB.
When you envision your future, do you see yourself making a real difference in the world? Keystone College graduates earn degrees in fields with some of the highest growth potential and impressive starting salaries. Choose from over 40 career-focused majors with flexible learning online or on campus. Keystone is a great fit with a welcoming and intimate campus experience, personal attention in classes, and real mentorship from your professors. Your career starts here at Keystone College. Lowest tuition, giant education.
Here we go.
Top four coming back at you at Christine Mathewson Field.
Leading off for the Eagles. Hold
as you're going to go ahead. Baseman. And you're going to have Josh Kohler lead off, a junior, or once again out of Popsky, New York. Zadamski working quickly. He to start the inning. First pitch. That's going to be a strike at the knees.
Here we go.
Kohler flew out to right field in the first inning. inning as Adamski comes set, deals. Next pitch at the knees, Adamski working quickly, getting ahead, 0-2. Next pitch from Adamski. Slider high.
Lock in.
Something you rarely see.
I think he wanted to see if Collin would swing at that high pitch because he's been aiming towards a little low in the strike zone, see if he would get him chasing high.
Changing the eye lever color a little bit right here. Let's see what he goes here. So next pitch. Change up right back up the middle. Goes past the Adamski over to J.D. Barrett, who flips on the Pager. Go over at first, and just like that, one away.
He is
going to go ahead.
Number 11,
Brad Edwards coming up. Up a senior, one of the few seniors, as you said before, out of East Brunswick, New Jersey, coming up to bat.
Edwards was hit by a pitch in his last at bat.
Absolutely, and I believe that was the first pitch of the inning from Adamski in the second inning. His first pitch, a little bit of a slider low on that one.
Here we go, DT, here we go.
Adamski just hitting his 40th pitch. It's not too long ago. His next pitch can also miss high.
That's it, Pat. Here you go. Here you go. You good?
This next pitch can be called a strike, Maribel. Edwards just taking all the way right there. Got hit by a pitch in the first inning. Ing went ahead. It took that one all the way. He just wants to hear strike one from Adamski. This next pitch. Slider outside once again. 3-1 is the count. Oh, coming in. Edwards, your starting left fielder for St. Elizabeth today. A 7-1 if you're just tuning in here. We're in the top of the fourth. As that pitch is going to be cut on and ripped into center field. Jason Thomas is going to go ahead and let that one drop right in front of him. And just like that, St. Elizabeth has a runner on first. First with one away.
Now batting the third baseman, number 28, Paul Hamilton.
You're going to get Paul Hamilton coming up to the bat. And now grinded into that 4-6-3 double play, that beautiful 4-6-3 double play. Hey, on that slow roller over to second base. That's Adamski's first pitch. It's going to be a cutter that just misses.
Lock in, come on.
The 1-0 coming in from Adamski, who comes set, deals. It's going to be a slider at the knees. Beautiful pitch there by Adamski.
2-4-1.
Next pitch. Slider in the dirt. Nice stop there by RJ.
Here you go, Pat.
Just to keep that right in front of him.
Shut your mouth.
Adamski, be 2-1. Buying an account, 2-1, one runner on first. Not a big lead. Is that pitch going to come inside? 3-1 to Hamilton. Third baseman for St. Elizabeth. Hamilton, another. Is that pitch going to be popped in the air? Center field. Jason Thomas going to come in, make the catch, and that's going to go ahead. That's going to keep Edwards over at first base. Here comes Zimmerman.
Now batting the designated here, number 35, Drew Zimmerman,
another her senior for the St. Elizabeth team out of Sayreville, New Jersey.
Here you go, Pat.
Zimmerman grounded out to second base in his first at bat. 0-1 on the day. His first pitch. It's going to be a strike in there. Adamski fine in the zone. Both teams relying heavily on their defenses today. Hey, we were talking about that before we came up for this half inning.
Yeah, I was mentioning before, there's been a lot of defense. There's been no strikeouts so far in 3 2/3 innings.
Yeah.
So far, they've basically been pitching to contact now.
Which is something that's not a bad thing.
No, it's not.
Dang, as that last pitch is going to go ahead and miss up the top. Up the 1-1. It's going to be caught on and missed. Adamski powering a fastball right by.
Thank you. Here you go, JT. Come on.
Zimmerman DHing today for St. Elizabeth. It says that Dansby's gonna come set and deal. Oh, runner takes off for second base. That's gonna be put in the air. Left center field. Adam Kelly clamps underneath it, makes the catch. It's in just like that. The Giants get through another inning. It is 7-1 for Giants.
The Giants 7, the Eagles 1.
Top of the order leading up.
Oh my God! Jigga!
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Each year, the Keystone College baseball team presents one of their own with a very special award, the Sean Murphy Number 22 Leadership Award. Sean Murphy was a pitcher for the Giants from 2009 to 2010 before being drafted by the Oakland A's in the 33rd round. In 2016, Sean was in AAA after battling back from injury and on the verge of breaking into the big leagues when he passed away suddenly. This award is given to a Keystone College baseball senior who demonstrates outstanding leadership, sportsmanship, academic performance, and commitment to the Keystone College baseball program. The recipient of this award will also wear Sean Murphy's number 22 game jersey for this year. This year's recipient of the award is senior infielder number 22, R.J. Goldsberry, who is also the CSAC Player of the Year.
Yeah, R.J.!
Congratulations, RJ, who will be batting third in this inning.
Here goes, come on, baby,
we are back here heading the bottom of the fourth. Top of the order due up for Keystone. I want to give a special shout out to Keystone College alum Conrad Holbrook out of Haymarket, Virginia, is watching the stream today, cheering on the Stone. Big shout out to you, man. Good to hear from you, brother.
Yeah, as you're going to go ahead, you're going to get the top of the order coming in here. J.D. Barrett going to lead off for the Giants.
Leading off for the Giants.
Here you go, J.D.
Barrett, two. J.D. Barrett, one for two on the day. He ground out to first base and ground out to first base and had a double in that huge second inning for the Giants. I want to thank everybody for once again tuning in here on this lovely, lovely Monday.
Yeah, as I mentioned before about Barrett, he's got two RBI, had that double down the right field line that brought home Pecorni and Abreu.
His first pitch is going to miss outside for a ball. One-0 for Barrett. Going to miss outside 2-0. Patella still on the mound out there for the Eagles. As you got a, looks like a lefty warming up in the bullpen for St. Elizabeth down the right field line. Next pitch to Barrett. It's going to be in the dirt. Patella having a hard time finding the strikes in there. Julio Acosta waits on deck. Next pitch, ball coming in. Patella just trying to find the strike zone on that one. As next pitch, it's going to be cut on. That's going to be right to center field. Going to go ahead and make the play. He is going to go ahead. That's going to be Pibrick, big number 22, who has Julio Acosta going to go ahead and dig in for the Giants here. Acosta 0-for-1 with a walk here. Granted, that's a short in the first inning, and then, as I said before, walked and scored a run. Run for the Giants. First pitch. Pibrick going to go ahead. Patella going to go ahead firing a ball right there. R.J. Goolsberry waits on deck for the Giants. So that's going to go ahead and be right back up the middle. Patella goes ahead, knocks it down, throws on the first. Just like that. 1-3. He put out is that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Sean Murphy Award winner for number 22, R.J. Goldsberry.
Number 22, R.J. Goldsberry.
You good, Leo? You good, baby? Come on.
Two quick outs here for the Giants. Ian and Patella, after that 7-1 second inning, really bounced back here.
You go, R.J.
This is the first pitch from Patella. It's going to be bounced in the dirt. Our first pitch ball.
You go, R.J.
Montone waits on deck. It's the next pitch. Oh, again, 2-0 to RJ. Patella falling on, Still falling behind a little bit here in the second, or in the fourth inning. But it's been productive. This is the next pitch. It's going to be cut on. On right back over here.
It's a glove he's catching.
Yeah, you're looking at him, my boy.
Patella taking about a quick walk around the mound real quick. He captures his thoughts and everything.
Here you go, RJ. Come on.
So RJ's going to go ahead and cut that one back in. RJ, 1-for-2 on the day. He with a hard hit fly out to center field and a double well back in the first inning. This deuce is wild here. 2-2, two outs. That's going to bounce in the dirt. 3-2 coming in full count.
Here you go, RJ.
As I said before, Montone waits on deck. The 3-2. That's going to be chopped over to third base. He's thrown on the first. And Hamilton goes ahead and makes that play. Hey, four quick ones here in the book. Score remains 7-1. We're going top five.
Four in the book, but
there's
still remaining.
Giants
7, Eagles 1.
There you go, DB. I love it.
At times like these, we lean on each other. Family, friends, neighbors, we're united in the fight. Geisinger was born more than 100 years ago in the face of another public health crisis. We beat that one, we'll beat this one too, by doing what we've always done, provide world-class health care to our neighbors and friends and their families. Long live heroes. Long live everyone.
Top five coming at you from Kiersey Mathewson Field as you're going to have Angelo Marabello. Oh, digging in. A junior out of Saddlebrook, New Jersey, catching today for St. Elizabeth. And for St. Elizabeth, trying to cut at this lead. Aid Marabella, as we said before, an honorable mention for the CSAC.
Here we go.
His first pitch from Adamski is going to be low. Marabell, went ahead, grounded out to third base in his first at bat here.
This
next pitch is going to miss 2-0. Marabell, Adamski at 55 pitches coming into this. So Adamski's next pitch. Misses 3-0. Adamski starting to lose the zone a little bit, but got to try and relocate. He has got 8-9-1 due up here for St. Elizabeth. That is next pitch. Adamski goes ahead, loses that one, and just like that, it's a four-pitch walk. Walk for Marabell, and that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Jack Tone, the shortstop.
Now that is the shortstop, number 12, Jack.
Here you go, 3-3, lock it, you good.
Damn. Tone also 0-for-1 on the day. Hey, with a ground out to first, is you're going to get a pitching mound visit. hit for Adamski.
Seems like every time we hit, there was a big fire last year down here. We lost our power and everything. I was screaming out the names without a mic. Stop it! I swear to God. I swear to God. I was screaming that out. Yo.
Here we go.
Just what you need.
And we're back here at Christy Mathewson Field. Followed as that pitching mound visit. Nick Gravel up in the Giants bullpen currently.
Here we go,
DT,
here we go.
As we said before, Jack Tone digging in. And his first pitch, God, I just missed. Jack Tone, another junior out of Bridgewater, New Jersey. He is, Tone is gonna go ahead. 1-0 from Adamski. Finds the zone. Going for a strike. Adamski, he's just trying to relocate that zone. Obviously, as you said before, there's no strikeout so far in this game, but as the 1-1, it's going to be in there for a strike.
I think we're a little bit concerned. I think that was Sean Stevens, the pitching coach, that was talking to Adamski during that mound visit. I think he was just making sure Adamski was able to relocate the zone after giving him that four-pitch walk. He's starting to relocate it.
As Adamski's going to go ahead and throw a curveball in the dirt. Heard RJ asking for an appeal over at third base, seeing if he went. But Tone went ahead, held up right there. Our third base umpire even confirmed it. It is Dempsey. He's going to go ahead. He's got a 2-2 count here. Here, Marabella on first base. He says that's going to be cut on a miss. Seven one once again. If you're just joining us here in the top of the fifth, nobody out here. We're running on first base, as I said before. Where is Marabello? Oh, his next pitch. That's gonna be cut on. Hit over to second base. That's gonna get through. That'll be a hit.
You good, Pat? You good, baby?
Hit. As Montone Field throws it back in, and just like that, St. Elizabeth's got something cooking a little bit here. Her runners now on first and second with the top of the order coming up. Oh, that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring on Joe Brung. As Jamie Shevchuk going to come in, and that looks like it's going to be the end of the line for Pat Adamski. As I believe we're going to get Nick Gravel coming in to pitch. As it is going to be Nick Gravel coming in to pitch. Bitch, we will be right back after this.
There it is, TT. Good work, baby. Good work. Good work, kid.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Now pitching for the Giants, number 40, Nick Gravel.
Here you go, Gravel.
Nick Gravel. Here you go, Nick.
I take,
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Christy Mathewson Field here as Nick Gravel is going to go ahead and take over for Pat Adamski. And as you're going to get the top of the order, Joe Braun and Jamie Shevchek not taking any chances here for the Giants. It's giving Adamski the quick hook. Because as I said, Gravel's first batter going to be facing is Joe Braun. He's got two runners on right now with nobody out. As Gravel's first pitch, he's going to come set and deal. Braun showing bunt, but pulls back. That's going to be 1-0. Adamski, not a bad line to show for right now. Four innings pitched, four hits, one walk, no strikeouts. That's a one-hit bat, man. And, but as I said before, those two runners on second and first are his responsibility right now. Oh, it's Gravel's next pitch, 1-0. That's going to be bunted into play. Hatzel feels, he's just going to eat that one. Bunt as what looked like was going to be a sacrifice bunt turns into a hit, and now you got Otero coming up, and just like that, St. Elizabeth has something cooking right here.
Now batting, second baseman, number 14.
A nice bunt there by Braun. Down the third base line. Hatzel tried to field it. Couldn't really do anything much about it. Braun had that beat, and the runners that were going to second and third were able to get there in time, so we just had to hold it.
Absolutely, as you're going to have Justin Otero, as we said before, dig in, made the second team for all CSAC right now, as first pitch from Gravel is going to go ahead in there for a strike. Otero, 1-for-2 today with a pop out, with a foul out to first base, and a double. Well, in St. Elizabeth right now, have something cooking, as I said before. This is Gravel's next pitch. It's going to be fouled back, and just like that, Gravel to the head, 0-2. Giants are here, you would assume, potentially would trade two runs, or two outs for a run here if you get a double play. He comes to the corners, you're probably going to be seeing it coming home.
Here you go, Gravel, come on, man. Here you go, 40.
As Gravel's set in the 0-2. Pitch. That's going to be chopped on the ground, found in fair territory. That's going to be called time, as they're going to be calling it foul, as it seemed as though it hit Otero in the box. So Otero getting a little bit bailed out right there, as that could have been trouble right there for St. Elizabeth. We'll go ahead, we'll have to reset, do that again. And his Gravel comes sit and deals. That's going to be cut on and missed. And just like that, we have our first strikeout of the game. Game, curveball in the dirt. Here, Gravel got Otero chasing, and that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up the paperwork.
Well, it took us 4 1/3 innings, but we finally got that first strikeout.
Here we go, Gordon. Here you go, Gravel. Come on.
Absolutely, yes. As I said, but just because you got one strikeout does not mean you are out of the woods yet. As you got, as I said before, Pitford coming up, who got to keep in mind, yesterday had two home runs against the Giants in game two.
He's currently 0-for-2 on the day, looking to get his first hit in game three.
Yeah, two pop outs to second base on this one. This Gravel's going to go ahead, come sit, and deal. That's going to be chopped on the ground, down right in front of the plate. RJ heads up baseball. Not trying to think too much, runs home with it. Very smart. part, as you're gonna go ahead, you're gonna
come on, Gravel, come on,
hey, Kohler, come up to the plate. Come up to the plate right now. Oh, and again, that's something rare. You usually don't see that.
You don't rarely see. It was a little bit of a kind of a check swing. Swing by Piperczyk, and RJ, he knew the bases were loaded, and he saw that runner coming for home, so let me just get the out at home, make sure no run score. Got two outs. Bases are still loaded, however, as Collar's at the dish.
Yeah. Kohler goes ahead, deals, pulls, gets that one in there. Turn for a strike. Gravel, finding a little bit of confidence right here, and this is exactly what you wanted is from Gravel. As you said before, Kohler 0 for 2 on the day with a fly out to right and a ground out to second. In his next pitch, curveball in there. A little bit of a 12-6 curveball right there.
That was a nice breaking ball by Gravel.
You would have to assume here, two straight breaking balls. You would have to assume fastball coming in. And most likely from Gravel. Well, as Gravel works something, we haven't seen a lot here. Another 0-2 count. As the next pitch, fastball fouled off.
Hey, Gravel, come on, baby. Let's keep working.
Kohler should be relieved by that. He gets new life, steps out of the box just to kind of retrain his thoughts.
Yeah. Everybody, you got to readjust the Gravel. It throws a little bit harder than Adamski. So you got to adjust the pitch speeds and everything like that. Gravel throwing a little bit harder, trying to get that past him.
Here you go, Gravel.
As you hear this Keystone crowd starting to come alive a little bit here. Here is the 0-2. That's going to be cut on to first base. Pedro makes the play. And just like that, the Giants escape danger. And that is the light way to put that.
There it is, buddy.
Score remains 7-1 as we head to the bottom of the fifth.
The Giants 7, the Eagles.
What I liked about Keystone is the flexible schedules and how much they were able to work with me.
When I chose to go to Keystone, I chose to be a resident student, even though I lived close to campus. I felt that it would give me the best experience.
Keystone was a perfect fit for me. It truly felt like family and still is today.
I chose Keystone College, and then I chose to start my own business.
I chose Keystone College, and Atlantic Emergency Associates chose me.
I chose Keystone College, and then I started my own business.
Here you go, coach.
Yeah, coach.
All right, Vince. Coach. Leading off for the Giants. Here you go, Vince. Right fielder, number 7, Vince Monto.
Bottom 5 coming back at you here at LaPlume, Pennsylvania, and Christy Matthews in field. 4, 5, and 6 do up for the Giants. Montone Kelly. He had some. Oh, and it's been quiet. It has of these past couple innings. Innings as for Fitch, it's going to be chopped on the ground over to third base.
Yeah, since that 7-run second inning by the Giants, their offense has been held a little bit quiet as Patella seems to be regaining his composure.
Absolutely, and Patella still out there after 5 innings. Innings is next pitch. Slider. Or called for a strike. Montone taking all the way right there. Montone behind the count 0-2. Ooh, the next pitch. That's ball in the dirt right there. Adam Kelly waits on deck. Vince Montone, one of the many seniors of this Keystone College his Giants roster out of Oak Ridge, New Jersey, as the 1-2. That's going to be popped in the air. There. little bit shallow, a little bit.
Drop it!
That's going to fall right in the triangle right there. A little bit of miscommunication right there. He's going to take advantage of that, and he's going to reach with a single, and that's going to go ahead. It's going to bring up Adam Kelly.
There was miscommunication between the shortstop, I believe that's Tone, and then the left fielder, Edwards, and the center fielder, Pipersick. I think they couldn't see the ball because in the sun there was some miscommunication.
Face it here.
And the one thing that you got to keep in mind all the time, with baseball and everything, we talk about it all the time, whether on broadcast or not on broadcast, that triangle right there is where you'll see a lot of base hits die. And everything like that, where it looks routine, but that triangle, a lot of miscommunications. You got three guys calling for the ball. Well, a lot of base hits fall right there. As Adam Kelly's showing bunt. But that's going to go ahead. That's going to get that Montone over the first. Oh, that's going to get by the first baseman. That's going to get by the first baseman. Montone's going to reach.
Okay, let's go, Hats.
Well, as that's going to go ahead, that's going to bring up Montone or Chris Hatzel.
Now batting, get the pressure on him.
I go with the hit on
number 14.
Here you go, Chris.
As Adam Kelly, never thought I'd see this sentence in my ever before, but Adam Kelly reaches with a bunt base hit.
I think they just wanted to advance Montone over to second. Kind of an interesting strategy you saw there, but the throw, Batella threw the ball away from the first base, then advanced Montone over to third, so I got runners on the corners.
Absolutely. He's going to have Chris Hatzel.
Let's go, Chris. Stand on it, baby.
This is something we've become accustomed to with the Giants. It's and everything like that, whether they're up 7-1, whether they're up 8-1, whether they're up 9-1. It does not matter what the score is, because Coach Shevchek will always play small ball. As Patella is going to go ahead. Hey, go from the stretch. 0-1 to Hatzel. That's going to be put into play, right field. Montone will tag. Throw comes into second base, but nonetheless, it is a productive out nonetheless, as it is a sack fly by the first base. On the right field. Montone comes home. That run is unearned right now. However, it could become earned very soon.
Go, Bobby. Keep the pressure on him.
Boom. But as I said before,
don't back off.
Go 3-0.
Hold on.
That's Pedro Berry who's going to go ahead. He's going to dig in.
1-for-1 with a single, and then he was hit by a pitch in his last at bat.
Yeah, Berry, definitely trying to find something he can drive right here, Patella. Right now, 8-1 Giants now is the score. It's first pitch, curveball, high.
Good eye.
Good eye, Pedro. Come on, baby.
Patella, if you can believe it. Believe it or not, Patella, 61 pitches to this point. As that last one was pitch 62 as he checks on Adam Kelly. He over at first base, but yeah. 62 pitches for Patella at this point. Normally when you see an 8-1 ball game, you would see a higher pitch count, but not in this case, as Pedro chases a slider in the dirt right there.
Come on, baby, lock in. Come on, Pedro.
The 1-1. It's going to be cut on. Foul back.
Good piece.
Lock in.
Once again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in on this, again, beautiful afternoon. We've been due for a good day. Hey, and good weather for baseball. And you got a perfect weather afternoon. Who knows the 1-2? Slider in the dirt. Runner goes over to second base. Kelly.
Got him.
He got thrown out over at second base. Base. Heads up base running. Being by Kelly. However, got a little bit hung out to dry.
You good, Kelly. You good, baby. You good. Let's go, battle.
So we reset here. Patella gets to go back from the windup now. 2-2 to Pedro. That's going to be ripped on the ground. Over to third base. Great job right there by Hamilton just to knock that one down.
Come on, Bobby.
You okay, big boy?
Now batting the shortstop. Number one, Bobby.
I mean, that was hard.
I would go with the hits in the beginning.
Let's go, Bobby!
Pedro with a rope over the third base, and that, honestly, third baseman, that's why they call it the hot corner. That is so.
Here you go, Bobby!
Yeah, that was smoked.
Yeah, one of those where, again, it was roped as you get Bobby for corner coming up here. First pitch in the third.
Good eye, Bobby. Good eye, Bob.
Come on, keep it going.
Yeah, 29, just like that.
But, again, great job by Hamilton just to knock that one down. Next pitch. It's going to miss outside. 1-1. 68 pitches for Patella to this point, and again, and kudos to Patella. Nobody warming up in the St. Elizabeth bullpen, and so right now, maybe 8-1, but St. Elizabeth is rolling with Patella.
Backup is here.
As a 2-0, fastball just misses. 3-0 to Bobby. Jason Thomas waits on deck for the Giants.
My backup is here.
The number 9 here for the Giants. Hits, and the one thing you don't want, you do not want this to go back to the top of the order, as Bobby's going to go ahead and take a 4-pitch walk there. As again, that's going to bring up Jason Thomas for the Giants.
Jason, JT Thomas.
Let's go, JT!
Packed house here at Christie Mathewson Field.
Thomas 0 for 1 with a grounded out to pitcher. It was a sack bunt, which advanced McCourty to second and Pedro Abreu to third.
And then a 5-3 ground out to the third base in his last at bat. But again, that's something you expect out of a 9 hitter. Get the job done, use your legs and everything like that. His first pitch too, Jason is going to go ahead and miss up high. 1-0. Two out. As I said before, two outs here. Bottom five. Ives has the 1-0. Oh, JT's going to go. So that's going to go ahead. That's going to.
Nice catch.
As second catcher tried to call time. I'm 2-0. Jason did call time on that one, but was not granted. It's so. Nonetheless, though, 2-0.
Not sure if you saw it, too. There was a attempt to pick off at first. That ball almost got away. Great job from Kohler to get in front of it. That would have been
disastrous.
That would have been disastrous.
As the count goes 3-0. And the other reason that would be very disastrous, Pedro potentially would have scored. But the other thing to keep in mind, Bobby's quick. Again, another guy.
Depending on where, say if that ball did get away, depending on, McCourty probably would make it to third, depending on where.
As Thomas, this goes ahead. You had to imagine that. And after, I believe, 7 straight balls, almost literally took the bat off his shoulder and
he just wanted to hear the first strike.
That's all you gotta hear. Or sometimes as a pitcher as the 3-1. That's gonna be in there. 3-2, 2 outs. Runners are gonna be taking off with the pitch.
Keep it alive here, JT, keep it alive.
3-2, as I said before, 3-2 with the pitch. Patella deals. That's going to hit JT in the back. And just like that, this is not what you wanted if you're St. Elizabeth. It's going to go to the top of the order. And it looks like we are going to be getting a pitching change here. Patella is going to leave the bases loaded. As we got St. Elizabeth, as I said before, we got St. Elizabeth coming in here with a pitching change.
I'm right.
Just that will do it for Patella.
Hey, I appreciate you, man. I remember
you. Hey, don't doubt me, bro. You don't deserve it.
Have yourself a day, my man.
Damn, I'm sad.
Yeah, DB!
Yeah! We missed you, Harry! That's what we needed yesterday, bro. That's the same without you.
Yeah, we are getting a little lefty. The kid that could have done a strike.
Look at Coach. Yeah, Coach, win a run. Win a run, Coach.
Yeah!
Let's go, Brian.
Yeah, give it to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please?
He's good, right?
Now pitching for the Eagles, number 20, Tyler Munzel.
Oh my God, this guy's even worse!
Hey,
get him out of here! Should have left the last guy in.
Last time we saw this guy, he gave up 5 runs and 5 batters.
Hey, so he's in college?
Yeah,
he
we're
in high school!
This guy stinks! Let me get some of that water. I'm thirsty. I'm parched. Let's go, coach.
Here you go, coach.
Yeah.
Let's round it up.
Yo, I was listening to that commentary. That one with Kelly?
That Kelly was there.
You should have seen him do it like. I know, I saw it. I was like,
don't let us be a bad influence.
Pitching change for St. Elizabeth. Tyler Munzel now in for relief with the bases loaded going against the leadoff hitter J.D. Barrett.
Yeah, Munzel. Munzel, a freshman out of Oak Crest, New Jersey for the Eagles.
Has a 9.14 ERA, 2-3 on the season in 9 appearances, 6 starts. Struck out 17 batters and has pitched 21.2 innings this season.
And Munzel going to go at first pitch from him. It's going to be fouled off by JD. As he said before the break, Big St. Elizabeth trying to get that lefty-lefty matchup against JD. His next pitch is going to be low and outside, 1-1. Tell us that line as next pitch from Munzel. It's going to be a fastball on the outside corner. 4 2/3 inning for Munzel. Both 2 walks, no strikeouts, 2 hit-by-pitches. Is as the next pitch from Munzel. It's going to be chopped on the ground. That's going to be in between the hole. Oh, and that's going to be an infield base hit as nobody's paying attention as the ball got by second base. Heads up base running. Thing by Picorni and JT moving on down home. Oh, man, JT moving over to first. And that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Julio Costa.
There was a whole lot of confusion there. It was a slow ground ball that was right between the first and second baseman. I think Otero and Kohler were in the facility. No one was really paying attention. The ball got away, I believe, was from Otero, which advanced Picorni to home and Kelly to third.
And again, the thing that we talk about this all the time, and that's another thing that just came into play. Hey, St. Elizabeth right there. That triangle. Oh, we always talk about it. It is Julio Costa is going to go ahead. He's going to dig in for the Giants. 10-1 Giants. As that pitch is going to be swung on. That's going to be hit to left field. That ball is high. It is deep. It is going to find the gap. Woodward scores. J.D. Barrett hustling home. It is a 2-run double for Julio Acosta. And the Giants have busted this one open. It is now 12-1 with R.J. Doolsbury coming up.
I tell you what, Acosta was due for a hit like this.
Absolutely.
It was hit to left side. I tell you what, that was very close to being a home run.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, took it to the deepest part of the yard. All right, but I agree with you. That man was due. RJ going to go ahead. He's going to dig in. Oh. RJ gonna go ahead, he's gonna dig in right here. Is that next pitch? That's gonna be rubbed into left field. That's a base hit. Julio being waved home. RJ's gonna take second on the throw. Julio is in there. And just like that, the Giants once again cooking up. This is a 6-run, 1/5 inning for the Giants.
They're keeping the train moving. Goldsberry with the hit to left field. Acosta, I think, was going to go home no matter what. He was being weighed by Smythe, and Acosta's got speed too. Edwards knew that Acosta was going home. He's trying to get out at home. Goldsberry knew that immediately, was able to advance himself to second. So heads up base running by Goldsberry to get himself into scoring position, but also to help bring another run home for Keystone.
Absolutely, and the Giants once again batting around. That's going to go ahead. That's going to bounce in the dirt. That's going to be a wild pitch. Pitching RJ. Moving over to third base. And the Giants.
Hey, stop throwing it at Kelly. He's a batter, bro, right now.
Just finding ways to get, to get this run in.
Coach, start the boss.
13-1. 13-1 Giants. It's here, bottom five. Next pitch. It's going to be popped in the air about a mile high behind the dish. That'll find them the back road of College Road or College Avenue.
Here we go, Vince.
Yeah.
Next pitch in the dirt or low. Oh, as the count moves to 2-1. The 2-1 to Montone. That ball is going to be ripped once again down the left field line, and that is going to fall foul.
What? Oh. Here we go,
Vince. Here we go. Come on, Vince.
Lock it, man. Come on. It was great contact by Montone. Going down and getting that one.
Go, Vince.
And that's been a swing that we've been seeing a custom again for Montone. And as Monzo is going to go ahead and kick the curveball outside.
Here you go, Vince. Come on.
Count runs full.
Come on, Vince.
Full. Obviously. A lot better scenario than the bases loaded, but Esmanza's going to kick. Deal. That ball swung on and hit high in the air, deep to left center field. However, Piverick is going to go ahead, camp underneath that one, and make the catch. And just like that,
here we go.
Giants, it makes some noise, though. Six
runs off of six hits, two errors, a runner left on base. A big inning for... A big inning for the Giants.
13-1, we had top six.
Listen, you know that some people will always tell you to slow down, wait and see. This isn't the time for making big changes. Well, we're not some people. At Keystone College, we're ready right now to take all of your dreams, passions, and experience and better equip you for what lies ahead, whatever that may be. Online delivery and a focus on adult learners isn't new to us. Slow down. We're just getting started.
My name's Amelia, and we're at my house in Danville, Pennsylvania. I went ice skating with five of my friends, and I fell backwards. Legs aren't supposed to look like that. We went directly to Geisinger's ER. They decided that I needed surgery. Dr. Seeley would always make me feel like safe and comfortable. I use my leg for everything. Geisinger just helped me gain the ability to do all the things I love again.
The Eagles.
Yeah, as you said before, Edwards, Hamilton, and then Zimmerman do up for the Eagles. Hamilton 1-for-1 on the day with a hit by pitch and a single. So, very eventful day for Hamilton at the plate, if you will. Oh, but he's got to face Nick Gravel now. That was first pitch fastball, low and in there. Low and called the ball.
Number 11, Brad Edwards.
Gravel, got to see how he bounces back here after a 6-run on fifth. Next pitch, that's going to be popped in the air. Center field, Jason Thomas is going to go ahead, camp underneath that one, make the catch, and just like that, exactly what you want to hear, exactly what you want to see. He is Gravel, not showing any rust, gets a two-pitch flyout.
Hamilton.
As that's going to go ahead, that's going to bring up Cole Hamilton and the third baseman. This Giants
team. His name is Paul. I'm sorry, Drew. No.
Or Drew Hamilton, excuse me.
Drew Ham. No, Paul Hamilton.
Paul Hamilton? I was
Paul Hamilton. Hamilton. You said Cole Hamilton. I'm like, who's Cole?
Apologies on that one.
To Paul Hamilton's family, if you're watching this game, we'd like to apologize.
The chef does what he wants.
Hamilton is going to go ahead 0-1 from gravel. Another 12-6 curveball that's going to just miss a little bit right there. Whereas that's going to go 1-1. Gravel and Adamski, something they both gravel with that very good 12-6 curveball. Oh, it's fastball. Ball.
I needed that. That's a nice
gravel just went ahead, reared back. Nothing but power behind that fastball.
You get hot on.
Gravel, forgot to mention, in last year's CSAC Rookie of the Year. This gravel's going to come set and deal the 1-2. That's going to be fouled back into the creek.
Dang, we're running out of oil. $500 fine right there, literally.
Got a creek.
I repeat, we're
splash on that one.
Don't worry about it. It keeps cutting them out.
We'll attach it onto your tuition.
Hear this Keystone crowd starting to make a little bit of noise.
It's your entertainment.
1-2. Curveball in the dirt. Good block there by RJ. That's going to run the count even 2-2 now. Gravel at 17 pitches out of relief. Even for the Giants. That's the 2-2 to Hamilton. That's going to be fouled off right off Hamilton.
Oh my
shit.
God. Oh, my God. That's why he's a player of the year.
That was nasty, RJ.
That's our tournament. He's our player of the year.
That's ESPN's out there right there.
For those who just missed, I wonder what just happened here. Hamilton fouled the ball. Bounced off the dirt, went right into Goldsberry's catcher's mask, and they thought that the fans here thought that play was elite.
The 2-2. Ooh, slider gonna just miss. Gravel running this one in full 3-2.
Here you go, boy.
3-2, one out. Gravel sit and deals. That ball's going to be put into play. Shallow. Oh, center field. Cody moves over just a little bit. Makes the catch just like that. To Wade. Hey, that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up. That's going to go ahead and bring up the third.
That's how you catch.
The D.H. Zimmerman. In number 35, Drew Zimmerman coming in.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 35, Drew Zimmerman.
Yeah,
13-1 here. We're at Christy Matthews in field. Well, we are on the top of the sixth.
I got bad knees, coach.
It's first pitch from Gravel. Fastball in there. Gravel, something that we become accustomed to sometimes from these Keystone relievers, just rearing back and throwing heat. This Gravel's 0-1. Sets deals. That's going to be cut on, lined in the center field. That's going to drop in there here in front of Adam Kelly.
About time to hit one.
And just like that, Eagles keeping this one alive, keeping this top of the sixth alive. Five, as it's going to go ahead, that's going to bring up Mirabello. Oh, the catcher.
Number 13, Angelo Mirabello.
Gravel at 23 pitches in his relief outing. And definitely something you would love to see for this Giants team, getting Gravel a little bit of relief. That's first pitch from Gravel. Fastball at the knees, called a strike.
Attaboy, Gravel, here we go, baby.
Mirabello 0-for-1 on the day with a walk. Walk is the 0-1. It's going to be swung on in the dirt.
Zimmerman.
Zimmerman goes ahead. Hey, thought
about.
Took a little bit longer. first step over towards second base, but RJ could do a nice job making sure that didn't get too far ahead.
Nasty, she's like barely here right there. I even do speed drills out there.
0-2 from Zimmer.
Watch this.
0-2. Who to Mirabello? Oh, from Gravel. That's going to be roped into set. Right center field. That's going to find the gap. That'll get to the wall. Oh, Zimmerman zooming around. On second. Hey, that's going to go ahead. That will score. Or Zimmerman. And just like that, Mirabello gets an RBI double out of that one. A nice piece of hitting right there. Down 0-2. Who's shortened up. Hups just deposited that one to the opposite field right over her J.D. Barrett's head. And now we got Jack Tone coming up for the Eagles.
Yeah, great piece of hitting here by Mirabella to able to bring home that St. Elizabeth's first run since the top of the first when Joe Brung had that leadoff home run. Right center field, as soon as that ball got past Montone, there was a good chance that Zimmerman was going to score, which he did. And then Mirabella was going to able to advance into second with an extra base hit.
Absolutely, and again, him. And Zimmerman showing a little bit of speed right there. His first pitch from Gravel is going to be in there for a strike. Next pitch to Tone. That's going to be a high curveball. Oh, Tone, kind of like a little bit of a check
swing, but he went around.
Very defensive swing on that one.
Yeah.
And my apologies for cutting you off.
No worries, man.
As Gravel's going to get set for the 0-2, raises his hand and gets time called. Getting signals mixed up there from RJ. And Gravel trying to find that put away pitch here. As the 0-2, moving Gravel, set, deals. Curveball in the dirt. Again, almost another defensive swing from Tone right there, but this time able to hold up, and that's something that you need to start doing. Because, especially with check swings, you can't be getting too careless. As the 1-2 from Gravel, sets, deals. A little bit of a splitter in the dirt almost. Almost right there, so 2-2. Ooh, two outs. Well, it's runner on second. Deuces, wild. Old in a way. Gravel set, 2-2. Fastball at the knees. Gravel asking a little bit where that was, a little bit. As we got a 3-2 count working here. Nobody up in the Giants bullpen. Gravel 3-2 count. He's got first base open, but you also got the top of the order coming up. The 3-2. Fastball fouled off.
Here you go, Gravel. Here you go.
Come on, Gravel. Lock in, man. Come on.
Great at bat right here from Tone. Otis, he's just battling right here. And honestly, these at-bats go a long way, especially in a 13-2 game. Gravel trying to find the put-away pitch. It's the 3-2.
There it is.
That is going to miss just low. Oh, Gravel and RJ just asking where that had missed. That's going
to
go ahead. That's going to
miss. Was that not a strike?
That's going to go ahead. That's going to miss just low. Oh, and that's going to go back to the top of the order. Joe Brong coming into bat.
Here you go, Gavin. Come on, baby.
Second walk of the day for this Giants pitching staff. Joe Brong, as we said. Joe Brong, 2-for-3 as first pitch. That's going to be fouled off. Joe Brong, 2-for-3 on the day, as I said before. Started off the game with an absolute hoot of a way to start off the game, to say the least. He's leadoff home run for Joe Brong. So Gravel's going to come sit.
Now.
Gravel 0-1, just trying to find a pitch right here. RJ and Gravel kind of getting a little bit mixed up with their signals. That's the 0-1. As he's going to go ahead. Hey, check swing right there. Good job by Braun right there, just making sure he takes that one.
Here we go, Nick. Come on.
Gravel with a 1-1 count working right here. This next pitch. It's going to be chopped on the ground right back over here. Here, and just like that, Gravel once again ahead in the count. Two strikes, 1-2. Gravel coming set. Yeah, with the 1-2 right now. Runners on second, first and second. So it's going to go ahead. Another splitter for as RJ goes ahead, attempts to pick off over at first base.
That's what it is. First base, catcher. What can he do?
St. Elizabeth doing a great job right here. Her making sure that they go ahead and just is having a great eye working the count, getting in Gravel's pitch count up.
Might even help him a little bit.
That's Gravel's 2-2. Curveball high. And just like that, another 3-2 count for Gravel coming in here. And the difference with this one, runner's going to be on the move. Gravel sets, it's for the 3-2, kicks, deals. That ball is going to be a curveball in the dirt, and this is not what you wanted to see if you're the Giants right here. Gravel, with the bases loaded. Otero coming out to bat at 0-2. Otero, 1-2 on the day, but had that double, obviously, as I said, back in the third inning. But Otero, the lone strikeout victim of the day.
Hell yeah.
Gravel's got to try and work out of this. His jammies got in. First pitch, fastball low. Gravel. Otero, I believe, was the very first batter that Gravel wound up facing.
Yeah, and he was the lone strikeout victim this entire game.
This first pitch, his next pitch, gonna be fouled back. Gravel at 41 pitches is so far this game. Gravel comes set, deals, 1-1. Foul back once again. St. Elizabeth definitely staying alive on this one.
Come on, Nick!
Pittsburgh waits on deck for St. Elizabeth, and again, that is a guy you do not want to come up with the bases loaded in this situation. As the 1-2. Fastball fouled off. Off as Otero doing a great job staying alive here. Gravel, he doesn't have to get too fancy with it. Just try and throw a fastball. Gravel trying to power a fastball right by him here on this one. But you might see a curveball in this situation. As you're going to see a fastball at the knees. Called strike 3. And just like that. And Gravel tight ropes out of danger. And ladies and gentlemen, your score now 13-2. We go bottom 6.
Oh my God, is that Mondo?
Yeah. Yo, Julio.
In the books with your score remaining.
I don't hear nothing over there, man. What's wrong?
13 Eagles, 2.
It's my favorite pitcher.
Oh, look who it is.
Is that Mondo? Or should I say Bozo?
Yeah, DB! Yeah! AJ!
good. Woo! Way to carry that bag in the back. Shit, back.
Jesus Christ, walk right here right now. These guys are trying to get me. Jesus, 200 for that road, bro.
Kelly, I got in trouble in class because I was listening to the game and I heard your home run and I was like, let's go! They were like, yo, my fault.
Hey, hitter.
Let me get another one right here, Kelly. Here you go, coach. Oh, my God. Come on, coach. Don't blame it. Come on, coach.
We need to learn his name, man.
For the Giants.
Bottom six coming back at you from Christy Mathewson Field. Pulled as a little bit of a read. He said here as we got Adam Kelly leading off, and who can forget what happened the last time he led off an inning? Being a solo shot on him in the bottom of the second that really got this Giants lineup going.
That's the man right there.
This is a legend.
This is a man right here.
This is a legend right here. Living legend right here in front of your eyes.
Chris Hatzell waits on deck. 5, 6, and 7 for the Giants as slow curveball. Oh, works high and Kelly just spits on that one.
Come on, let me see something at least.
Kelly, one.
That's something, all right.
Yeah. That's going to go out. That's going to miss 2-0. Kelly, he 2-for-3 on the day with a single and, as I said before, solo home run. That really sparked this Giants lineup. Well, as Kelly looking to deposit that one on as well into the left field. Oh, there's a shed out in left field. Adam Kelly taking aim for that shed out there. That's a 2-1. That's going to be ripped on the line by the left field. That is going to be a base hit. Hit for Adam Kelly. And just like that, we said this before, we'll say it again. Leadoff man on for the Giants here, as that's going to bring up Chris Hatzell.
Something to notice about the Giants, JT, whenever they lead off the inning, usually the leadoff man has actually reached base. Now, I know it didn't happen the first inning, but I think the past couple innings we saw the leadoff man reach on base, which is a good sign from an offensive standpoint.
Absolutely, and another trend. Absolutely. The main thing that Giants need to start doing with this, though, with the leadoff man getting on, got to start cashing him in. As Hatzell is going to go ahead and again, that's going to get by. That's going to go ahead. That's going to get by the catcher. That's going to get by the catcher, Mirabello. Oh, and Adam Kelly is going to happily take second base on that one. Could have almost. Kelly almost could have walked to second base on that pass ball right there. Whereas, as I said before, Hatzell digging in right now.
Here you go, Chris. Come on, Chris.
Hatzell, 1-0. That's going to be grounded over to the third. Whereas Zimmerman makes the play, checks on Kelly, but throws on the first. 5-3 on that one. On as that's going to go ahead, that's going to bring up Pedro O'Brien.
Sorry, baby. Come on, go,
Pedro. Number 30, Pedro O'Brien.
Pedro Abreu making it on the CSAC, as I said before, CSAC honorable mention team. Giants right now, 14, out hitting the Eagles, 14-7 on this one. But the Eagles, 3 costly errors. It's Pedro's first pitch, going to be chopped on the ground. Third base once again, Zimmerman checks on Kelly, throws on the first. A little bit offline, but nonetheless,
yes,
first baseman. First baseman Kohler right there. Composes himself. Great job composing himself. Not getting too over ahead of it. Steps on first. That's going to go out. That's going to bring out Bobby McCormick, shortstop for the Giants.
They did that off the cruise!
Is Monzo going to go ahead? And his first pitch to Bobby.
Yeah, my boy, if you don't want to play, just leave,
bro. I like that song too much. We want to stop.
Here you go, Bobby.
Let's go, good.
Corny. Corny. 2-0.
What
was that last one? He's going to miss up there.
Let's go, Bobby. Let's go. This is your favorite player. Favorite player right here.
13-2. Ooh, two outs. Well, it's two ball. Well, there's no strikes to Bobby Vigorni. His next pitch. Nice curveball. Oh, that finds the zone. Cuts back inside. All right. Smonzo goes 2-1 to Bobby. Jason Thomas waits on deck. Next pitch. God, on the miss.
You good, man? You good? Lock in. Come on, kid.
Vigorni, 1-for-2 on the day with a walk. Walking a single and a ground out.
2-2.
This is going to go 2-2 here for Bobby. Is count now runs full, 3-2.
Don't get money. Dirty with your
Kelly on second, so luckily, runner isn't taking off for his third. The 3-2. That's going to miss low, and that's going to go ahead. Once again, that's going to bring up Jason Thomas. Is as Corny works his second walk, Jason Thomas going to dig in.
Jason Thomas.
Your own DMA champion, man. Come on. Let's go, JT.
JT, oddly on the day, 0-1. And normally, he with 3 at-bats on his plate, 8, you would expect more. You would be wondering why he's 0-1, but he's got a sack bunt and a walk as he almost added a hit by pitch to his ledger on that one.
Would have been a second if that hit him.
His second hit by pitch, yeah. As Thomas going to go ahead, 1-0. Curveball finds the zone. Monzo just trying to play catch right now. Oh, that's the big thing. Next pitch. Curveball once again misses. Monzo really going to that curveball a lot this inning. But it's been all reliable. Next pitch. That's going to be popped in the air back here. It's going to just miss our 10.
I got it! Woo! Yeah, JT, we got your ball!
As you got Deuces Wild once again on the board. 2-2, two outs. Oh, it's smart. Two runners on first and second. That's the 2-2. That's going to be cut on. That's going to go in the left center field, but Piprick is going to be right there, makes the catch, and just like that, Giants.
It's in the book.
Leaf 2 stranded, but nonetheless, 13-2 remains your score here.
Eagles 2.
Yeah, D-Man! Yeah, D-Man! Yeah, well,
let me tell you something. What's that like? I couldn't do this one. Guy right now, I give it up. That's the one that said, yeah, they know.
How are you doing? I know that.
Here.
Leading off the seventh for the Eagles, your center fielder, number 22, Jake Pivacek.
Back here at La Plume, boom, is Jacob Pivacek is going to go ahead. He's going to dig in here. We're 13-2 Giants here as we start the top of the seventh. 3-4-5 for St. Elizabeth due up, and that's something you would love to hear. You'd love to hear leading off an inning, no matter what the score is.
Here we go, Nick. Come on, Nick.
Let's go.
It's first pitch from Gravel. Woo! Fastball at the knees. Call it for a ball. Oh, 1-0.
Here you go, Nick. Here you go, Gravel. Come on.
Let's go, Gravel.
Gravel going ahead. He's going to get set. Deal. The 1-0. Fastball at the knees. That's a strike. Like, Gravel didn't have to do too much on that one. Just raise it just a hair high. A hair higher. And you get the call.
Show him that secret sauce.
So Gravel's going to come set the 1-1. It's going to be a fastball at the letters. That's going to be called a ball. 2-1.
Here you go, Gravel. Get in, baby. You good?
Come on, baby. Lock in, lock in.
St. Elizabeth has a little bit of action going down in there. Her bullpen down the right field line. Looks like a righty up for St. Elizabeth. That's going to go out. That's going to be fouled back. And Gravel just trying to throw. Gravel right now throwing nothing but fastballs. Piprick right here. Or like that, just trying to overpower him, go power versus power.
Here we go, Nick!
Piprick.
Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby.
Piprick 0 for 3 today. 0 for 3 with two pop-outs to J.D. Barrett and a...
Let's go, Nick!
He that had that weird catcher's unassisted fielder's choice as next pitch, curveball.
Let's go, party.
Just misses 3-2.
Come on, Nick.
Let's go, Nick.
Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby.
Yeah!
Gravel with the 3-2 coming in. Kicks, deals. It's going to be fouled back at right at the net.
Can't do it to cut that.
Piprick. Piprick doing a great job here, staying alive.
Let's go, Nick. Let's go, Nick.
Here you go, Gravel.
Kohler, the first baseman, waits on deck. The 3-2. That's going to be popped in the air. Behind the first baseline. I mean, that's going to go ahead. That's going to get out of play. Hey, and just like that, Piprick going to go ahead. Hey, keep alive here. Piprick, I was he constantly are mentioning Piprick had two home runs yesterday in the contest against the Giants, and ironically, his first of two came in the top of the seventh.
Let's go, Nick! Woo!
Gravel sets, deals, the 3-2. Fouled off again. This is a great battle for Piprick here.
Yeah, Piprick just trying, just been finding the pitches. Just he's chipping them off. He's hitting them foul. So he's staying alive. Just looking for that pitch to make contact on and try to get a hit.
Absolutely. And the one thing to keep in mind, Gravel has shown on pretty much almost all fastballs this.
Here you go, Nick.
He's in 3-2 counts to Piprick here. So he's
8 pitches so far this at bat.
Gravel 3-2. Curveball just misses for a ball. Oh, and just like that, great at bat by Piprick right there. Her works the walk, and that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring out the first baseman, Kohler.
Now batting the first baseman, number 8, Josh Kohler.
As Kohler's going to go ahead, as I said before, Kohler's digging in here. Thing with Kohler. And this is something we've said rarely for St. Elizabeth. St. Elizabeth has their leadoff man on. This first pitch. Fastball high. Gravel 1-0.
Here you go, Nick. Come on, kid.
Gravel with the 1-0. gonna be fouled off in the creek.
That's $1,500.
Pedro not necessarily holding. Being Piprick over at first base all that hard.
Here you go, Nick.
Because right now, up by 11, don't necessarily have to worry about the runner on first base, as we're gonna get a pinch.
Only worried about him there.
That time.
Usually
up 11, you're not necessarily showing a little bit of care. That time, figure, make sure where he realized Piprick was a little bit important. And over at first base, as next pitch, as Piprick's going to go ahead, he's going to take off. A little bit of a hit and run action right there. Everybody saying Elizabeth.
That was a great jump by Piprick.
Fantastic.
Piprick, I mean, he started to take off as soon as gravel was winding. He would have been safe easily.
Piprick?
If Cola didn't swing at that pitch.
Piprick was right by gravel on the first base side.
Go, Nick.
Right by second base. He's right now. Kohler with the 1-2. Now you got to be wondering, is this hit and run going to be on once again? Piprick stays put, and Kohler. Kohler using that very tall stance of his is to his advantage. It's normally. And Kohler doing a great job not chasing that fastball low. Oh, his next pitch. That's going to be cut on. That's going to go right into that triangle out there. Once again, that's going to fall for a hit. However, Piprick had to wait and see if that was going to fall in for a base hit. It did not. So that turns into a fielder's choice. 4-6.
Let's go, JD. Good shit.
Yeah, costly first out for St. Louis. And I wouldn't really put the blame on Piprick because, I mean, it was a tough play between Barrett and Montone. The question was that ball going to drop fair? And it did drop fair. Piprick knew it, started taking off, but Barrett was able to get the out at second.
And again, that's no fault on Piprick or anything. Because, again, play like that, you got to stay close to first base because as first pitch to Edwards is going to be fouled back. Because the thing with that is you got to make sure. Because you can never really tell if that's just going to land in the triangle,
exactly.
If it's going to land fair or foul. So you got to stay close to first base, especially with the positioning of the ball as well. Oh, because the closer it is to first base, the easier the throw. Oh, so his next pitch slider going to be called for a ball right there.
Yeah, Nick!
Yeah, baby, come on, lock it.
Giants right now, 1-1 to Edwards, the number 5 hitter for the St. Elizabeth Eagles. As next pitch, a little bit of a slider right there from gravel. Kind of just got away from him right there. Edwards, great job ducking away, and RJ even just as good of a job making sure that did not go to the backstop.
Let's go, baby, let's go.
Gravel going ahead, checking on Kohler over at first base now.
Yeah, Nick!
Here you go, Nick!
Let's go, baby, let's go.
His next pitch is going to be a ball at the knees right there. Or on a fastball, Gravel.
Come on, Nick, let's find it here.
Gravel at about
50. Come on, baby.
Gravel about 62 pitches in his relief outing right now. As the 3-1. That's going to be caught on a missing. Gravel right now. Well, strict diet of fastballs coming.
Yeah, the thing with Gravel, too, and he knows that he's doing it well. He gets ahead in the count. Next thing you know, he works these full counts, whether he's at 3-1 or he's full. He gets ahead, then he starts working backwards a little bit. And that's kind of somewhat the reason why his pitch count is a tiny bit high.
His next pitch is going to be a splitter in the dirt. There it is. That's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Hamilton, the first baseman. Runners on second and first.
It's Gravel's fourth walk.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
You good, baby? You good?
You got RJ coming into the mat, coming for a mound visit. And this is honestly a great move by this Giants. His team just getting Gravel. Going over to the mound, Gravel right now, as I said before, 64 pitches in this outing. Ain't no Jamie. He coming out to potentially relieve Eve Gravel. Well, as Gravel's going to try, as they might go ahead, Gravel might be finishing this inning out. Oh, yes, one out. Yes, there is one out here, but again, this is a great move by RJ.
Here you go, Gabby. You're good, baby.
Let's go, baby.
Let's go, kid. Come on.
Lock in, lock in.
Yeah, where the fans at, bro? Let them relax for a couple
times. 3-2.
Now batting third baseman, number 28, Paul Hamilton.
Paul Hamilton digging up for St. Elizabeth. And again, we were just talking about this. Yes, that was a great move by RJ. He took the lead as that pitch is getting fought. That pitch is going to go ahead and roll to the back of the dugout. And just like that, St. Elizabeth has two guys on second and third now. It's Edwards and Kohler. And Kohler both advance on the pitch. Grab about 65 pitches right now, which is, again, something that a lot of managers love to see out of long relievers and everything like that, getting these long relief outings, going in 65 pitches and everything. There's one over from Gravel. Bounce in the dirt. Gravel starting to lose a little bit of command.
You good, baby. Come on.
Come on, Nick.
Let's go, kid. Come on, you good.
Just want to keep in mind here, a walk is not the worst thing for the Giants because that does set up the force at any base. Ace, you just can't let anything get away here. As the 2-0. Fastball foul on back. Guys, as I said before, something you'll see a lot from pitchers when they get higher into relief outings, you'll see a lot more fastballs than you will curveballs, breaking balls. Simply because of the fact that fastball got a lot more control over it, especially when you're getting tired or especially when your pitch count is high. Is that it? As that next pitch is going to be deposited into center field, well, one run will score. Two runs will score, and just like that, St. Elizabeth puts up a two spot here. It is now 13-4. As I said before, Hamilton goes ahead. It gets a single, and that looks like it's going to be the end of the line for Gravel here. As we are going to be getting a pitching change coming in. As I said before, Coach Shevchek not taking any chances.
Julian, call back here.
Because we're going to be getting... Because we're going to be getting Julian Gonzalez coming in for the Giants. We will be right back after this pitching change.
Let's go, Jago.
Hey, let's go.
Come on,
let's get out.
Let's go.
Out of board, Nick. Out of board, Nick.
Come on, Nick.
Here you go, Nick.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. Come on, pick it up. Pick it up.
Yeah. Good stuff, Warro. Good stuff, baby.
I need the fans to be louder, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Now pitching for the Giants, number 51, Julian Gonzalez.
Yeah!
You good, kid? You good? Come on, let's go. Get warmed up.
Hey, come on, hey! Yes, yeah, boss!
Julian Gonzalez now in relief for Gravel.
This is the man I want on the plate right now, baby. Let's go, Jake.
Yeah, 51, Julian Gonzalez coming in to relief for the Giants. It's here.
Let's go, Jake!
Julian, 2-3 on the season with 9 appearances, 5 starts with the Giants, 6.48 ERA. His first pitch is going to be a fastball strike. Runner on first base, 1 out. Up for the Giants here. As next pitch from Julian. Fastball just outside.
Let's go, Jim. Come on, man.
Julian, as I said, 2-3, 6.48 ERA. Hey, on the season. And his next pitch is going to just miss 2-2.
Let's go.
The 2-1 for Julian. That's going to be ripped on the ground. First base, Pedro, great job stopping that one. Just getting in front of that one. That was smoked on the ground, and just like that, 2 away. However, Zimmerman advances over to first base. Or over to second base, excuse me, and that's going to bring up the catcher, Mirabella.
Batting the catcher.
Yeah, it was a good stop by Abreu right there. Couldn't find the ball for a little bit, but he was able to find it, retain it, able to get the out at the out of first. 2 outs, and Julian now on an out away to get him to get the Giants out of this little run that St. Elizabeth has started.
Absolutely, and the other thing too, this is what you need from Gonzalez right here. His first pitch, it's going to be a fastball, just misses.
I don't think so.
All right, Jay, come on, baby. Let's go.
Gonzalez. Gonzalez's next pitch is going to bounce off the glove of RJ and get by. All right, that's going to be a passed ball right there.
Hey, let's go, Jay.
Let's go, Jay. Come on, man.
End the game, baby. You good.
Julian, again, usually a spot starter for the Giants and everything like that, which, again, does have relief outings. However, as we all know, game 3, winner take all. Oh, this is all hands on deck. Heck so. As Gonzalez is 2-0. It's going to be a fastball inside. Julian trying to find the zone here.
Let's go, Jay. Come on.
Julian's just got to bear down here, find the zone. Oh, and just firing a strike right here. 3-0. Fastball going to just miss.
Hey, you're good, baby. You're good. Let's go.
And that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Jack Tone, the shortstop.
Now batting the shortstop, number 12, Jack Tone.
Deep breath, Jay. You're good, baby. Jack
Hawker. Ain't nothing but a beautiful man pitching up there.
Tone 2-3 on the day with a trip, or with a walk and a, or excuse me, he's 1-2 on the day with a walk and a single. As Julian refining the strike zone. Oh no, that's something you need. Key for Julian right here. RJ getting out the signs.
Yeah, it's out of RJ.
As the 0-1, fastball high. All right, 1-1 from Gonzalez. 13-4 here. Bottom, top seven. And the Eagles have put up a two spot here. We're in the top of the seventh as Gonzalez's next pitch. Gonna miss high. 2-1 at the letters.
Let's go, Jake. Lock in, baby. Come on.
The 2-1 to Tome. Fastball just misses.
Lock in, lock in. Let's go.
Come on, Jake.
As it is 3-1. You don't want to load the bases here. You want to get out of this. You want to get back to that dugout as soon as possible. As Gonzalez, 3-1. Fastball in the zone. Runner on first is going to be taking off here. Where is Gonzalez? He just has to play catch with RJ at this point.
Come on, Jay.
Gonzalez looks in, kicks, deals. Fastball outside, fighting just like that. Bases are now loaded with the top of the order. Here, Joe Braun coming up to the bat.
Now batting the right fielder, number 4, Joe Braun.
Hey, let's go, G. You good, baby? Come on. Deep breath, deep breath.
Yo, who?
Braun, 2-for-3 on the day with an RBI. Right, Gonzalez is going to go out. He's going to step off real quick. First pitch. It's going to be caught on a foul, Braun. St. Elizabeth, if right now, as I said before, are three runners on 13-4, or down by 9. Fine, next pitch, curveball in there as Gonzalez refining the strike zone. This is what you like to see out of him.
Yeah, it's been the struggles with the Giants probably around the halfway point of this game is just finding the strike zone, just walking. The walks have added up here, so they're looking to get out of this here.
That last pitch missed for a strike zone at this point. Sometimes even with these 0-2 counts and everything like that, you see with the Giants, sometimes Giants are just looking to be a little bit too fancy with everything and just trying to make a perfect pitch, quote unquote. Gotta just try and go at the guy. All right, as the 1-2. Curveball, that's gonna be put into play. Center field, Jason Thomas underneath it. Makes the catch, and just like that, Giants give up 2, but tightrope out of a lot more dangerous situation than what they had. And score is now 13-4. St. Elizabeth somewhat chipping away. Hey, we go bottom 7. Get up and stretch.
My name is Harry. I was born and raised in Ashley, Pennsylvania. I was at the golf course the one day and I got some chest pain. When they were doing all my workups for my heart surgery, someone noticed that I had an arterial venous fistula up in my brain. He said if that thing burst, it could be a goner. Dr. Shermer said he would go right through my forehead. Scars right here where Dr. Shermer did the operation, right there. Can't even see it, it's in my wrinkle. Retirement's great since Geyser has me all fixed up.
A little more.
I'll go over there running and get for you.
As long as you sign it for me. As long as you sign it.
I'll get it. Climb the fence and be
the guy. Let's go, Johnny.
Let's go, Johnny.
The second baseman.
Bottom seven here in LaPlume, Pennsylvania, is Jaden. As you hear the fans going at it, J.D. Barrett's going to go ahead. He's going to dig in into the plate. Giants trying to get two of those runs back. Heck here. That's first pitch to J.D. That's going to be put in the play. Left field. Left fielder camps underneath that. Edwards makes the catch just like that. One pitch went away. Hey, that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Julio Acosta.
Number 10, Julio Acosta.
Yeah, Julio.
Wait, this is not just 22 compared to bat. No, this is player of the year, 22 ready to bat.
Once again, Acosta digs in. In first pitch, curveball. Oh, I'm going to just miss on that one.
I'm trying to hit my boy, bro.
RJ waits on deck. Next pitch, similar pitch to the one we just saw right there. Julio trying to get out of the way of that one. Fastball high. Julio playing a little bit of limbo on this one. In this at bat here.
He's been moving around. There's been pitches that have been inside. That one's a little bit high. He's been moving around.
As next pitch, it's Julio just hearing strike three on that one, and that's something.
Strike one.
Or strike one on that one. My apologies. As there is ball four. Or that's going to bring Julio over to first base. And RJ, you're going to go ahead, dig in now.
Number 22, RJ Goldsberry. Yeah.
T-Zack, player of the year.
Your worst nightmare, Mondo.
It's Montone's going to go ahead. He's going to come on deck. RJ digging in so far. RJ 2-for-4 on the day with a double and a single. First pitch is going to be swung on, and that was hammered right to left field.
That ain't just a foul ball, no. That's a foul ball by player of the year, number 22.
Don't worry, Monzo, he's just teasing you.
RJ does have one of the Giants' lone RBIs on the day. This next pitch, curveball, just misses.
You didn't just throw a ball at any player, no. You threw a ball on player of the year, number 22.
St. Elizabeth has a righty up, working in the bullpen. RJ with a 1-1 count, but that one strike was a loud strike. Next pitch, ball. The 2-1. Slider just missed. This is the end, just like that.
Let's go, RJ!
Just like that, Monzo, he's behind again. 3-1. Onto another batter.
This is the part of the lineup, too, you do not want to get behind.
Absolutely not, as the next pitch, 3-1. In there for a strike. RJ just listening for a strike. Thank you.
Come on, baby. Show him.
Because Monzo this inning. That's Monzo's third strike of the inning. He's going to go ahead. He's going to step off here.
Clear the ear, waving it off.
Keep the ball in the bullpen, please.
Thank you.
Julio's going to take off. That ball is going to be popped in the air behind the second base bag. Julio's going to get back. He will. That's going to drop up as that's now going to be a knock. As that's now going to be a knock. Again, another weird one coming at you. That's going to be a 9-6 fixed fielder's choice.
That was an interesting scenario there.
Yeah, you usually don't. Usually you don't see that.
No, I'm not sure if Otero lost the ball in the sun on purpose because they wanted to get the runner out at second, or he literally couldn't see it. I mean, they got an out, but that was interesting.
It definitely was. Montone's going to take first pitch strike on that one. But again, and the sun and everything ain't definitely going to be playing a factor throughout the day and everything. Ain't going to, we've seen it before. We will continue to see it all day. As Montone's going to rip that one to the left side. That's going to be a base hit. And RJ, hey, unhooking the trailer, goes over third, makes it in there. Aaron, just like that, heads up base running by the Giants, going first to third. And this is the part of the lineup up where first and third. Adam Kelly coming up to the bat, to the dish. And maybe we remind you more, or as we're going to be getting a pitch hitter coming, or a pitching change coming in. Excuse me.
No, that was a slap up player of the year, number 22 up third. Yeah!
Monza, go warm up that bus for me, will ya?
Try to stay at the middle on one.
Hey, don't look over here.
Yo, who put this song on? It's he. That's got to be my boy, Adam Kelly.
See you later, Monza.
Woo! Let me see it again. Hey, that's a long walk, ain't it, 20? You know what's even longer? The bus ride home after losing. That's not just any player over there on third on one knee. No, that's player of the year on one knee, number 22.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I please have your attention, please?
What?
Now pitching for the Eagles, number 32, Diego Rodriguez.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, yeah, I like that.
Coach, I think this one's worse.
I think you got your lineup backwards.
Hey, turn the page over, coach.
Flip it upside down.
Do it for me, Chris.
Oh, yeah, Chris, come on, baby.
I'm still watching you. You're not doing so good. Oh, my God. Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I think I've seen enough.
What? Oh, my God, again? Yeah. Yeah, Chris!
What a throw, Chris. What a throw, Chris. There it is, man.
The arm catcher better than the catcher.
Absolutely.
Uh-oh, here it comes. Number
10. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Christy Mathewson Field here. First, we got a pitching change for you. Diego Rodriguez out of South Amboy, New Jersey. And something we haven't said in a while. A freshman pitcher for St. Elizabeth coming into the mound. And welcome. Welcome to the mound. Oh, Mr. Rodriguez, you get face number 31, Adam Kelly, who again has one home run on the day.
Rodriguez this season, 0.75 ERA, 1-1 on the season, has appeared in four games with two starts. He's pitched 12 innings this season with 7 strikeouts and 10 walks.
I want to keep something in mind with that one. With one of those starts, was a complete game. Game, so. His next pitch is going to go ahead and miss up high. So it's going to be a 1-0 count.
Bring back Mondo! Bring back Mondo! Did you not learn the first time? Damn, man!
Bitch is too fast! He's too quick!
Yo, Kel.
And his beard is too thick!
Yeah!
The 1-0 to Kelly.
That's
good. Best eye, Cal.
Good eye.
C-Sack Peter of the year. You know who I go to?
Rodriguez having a hard time finding the zone here.
Let's go, Kels. Come on, Kels.
Come on, Kel, RBI here.
Here you go, AJ.
The girl's really
2-0. Fastball finds the zone.
It took him a while to find the zone. Those first pitches were way out of the zone, and finally getting that first strike called.
And that's the thing right now with Kelly. He has that. Hey, we say it all the time with Kelly. Kelly trying to aim for that. Again, there's a shed in left field, just outside of left field. Kelly taking aim for that shed. That's the 2-2 to Kelly. Fastball high. Montone's going to come up. Going to get into a little bit of rundown. RJ heads up base running, comes home with it. Hit, and RJ. And Montone takes second. That's something the Giants have done so many times over the years. And that's something you can't do as a catcher. Especially whether it's two outs, one out. You cannot throw down to second base. Ace with runners on the corners right there. You just got to let the runner get on to second base.
As I said before, that's not any other Keystone baseball player that scored. That's the C-Sac player of the year, RJ Goldsberry, that scored.
As Kelly's going to go ahead, caught on a miss.
The
Giants tack on a run, and it is now 14-4.
Where's EB?
I'm back.
Number 22. Oh my God. That's not just any woman here, no. Not the wife of Player of the Year, number 22.
Don't
ruin
my next year.
Let's go, Jay!
Close my PK, game of the year.
Let's go, Jay. Good luck in, baby. Come on.
Let's go, Jay. I would have swung at that. I would have shook out right there.
This is your game, baby. Come on.
What that clutch in at 110?
Yo, Noah, who's coming out right now?
Hey, that's not just any player coming out, no. That's player of the year, number 22. Yeah! Woo!
The boy can do anything.
Woo! That's not just any player hitting, no. That's a loser, number 14. Yeah! Woo!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Keystone College and Christine Matheson Field. Well, top eight, two more innings to go, ladies and gentlemen.
The Eagles,
and as you're going to go ahead,
number 14, Justin Otero.
As you're going to go ahead, you're going to get Justin Otero, the two hitter, due up for St. Elizabeth. 2, 3, and 4 due up. One for St. Elizabeth. Is that first pitch from Gonzalez is going to be ripped down the line. That is going to be a foul ball.
What?
Oh.
Almost.
You almost had me there.
Otero giving that ball a little bit of a ride. As I said before, Otero on the day so far, 1-for-4. Or with a double. Well, but the thing to keep in mind, Otero, the only Eagle to be striking out today. He struck out twice. Gonzalez taking a little bit of time on this one. Gonzalez composes. Next pitch. Curveball in the dirt. Got two Giants warming up in the bullpen. And down the left field line.
Come on, Jake!
Come on, Jacob, come on!
Two pitchers it looks like getting warmer. Number 11, Logan Lixie, and number 50, Nathan Hinckley. His next pitch. Popped in the air. Shallow left field. That's going to drop in that little area between Picorni and Kelly. He unfortunately was too far. Was too far for Picorni to get to, and it was too shallow for Kelly to get to. So, but just like that, but Otero, he's got a base hit. Hit on the day. Now that's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up the center fielder, number 22. Ooh, Jacob Persick. Wind picking up just a little bit here over at Christy Madison Field. That's Austin's first pitch. Bunt being shown. RJ trying to throw. RJ trying to throw out the runner at Otero over at second base. Or over at first base, excuse me, RJ. He just a little bit high with that one. If RJ throws that on the money, we could potentially be talking on that one. The 1-0. Everett's showing bunt. St. Elizabeth trying to play a little bit of small ball here.
Come on, Jay, come on!
They're down 14-4. To the street. 2-0. Everett's gonna go ahead and take that one all the way. 2-1 right there.
Like
a 2-1. Fastball high. Hi, Julian. Just trying to find the strike zone. He's got to play catch right now. Oh, not really worry about much. You're up by 10. And just try and find the zone here. That's the next pitch, 3-1. That ball's going to be ripped to left field. That is high, and that is foul. Also, Julian getting back into it. 3-2 here. Main question you got here is this going to potentially be something that St. Elizabeth has been doing a lot here with 3-2 counts? Is, are you going to be seeing a pit and run go here right now? His next pitch is going to be missed just low as Julian couldn't find the zone right there. Aaron, just like that, full count walk. Walk sends pitcher. Just like that, Pippert goes ahead.
Number 8.
Sends it over to first base.
Kohler.
He says that's going to bring up Josh Kohler right now. Kohler, quiet in the 4 spot today. 0-for-4 on the day. This first pitch. Pitch fastball in the dirt. RJ throws down to second. That ball kind of got away a little bit from JD, but great job by Bobby tracking that one down, keeping Otero over at second base. The 1-0. Fastball finds the corner. Finds this corner for a strike. Mike, and just like that, Julian 1-1 right here. 1-1 count, no outs. Julian's got to get an out here. Or you would have to assume. Next pitch, foul. Back 2-1-2 here. Julian a little bit over 30 pitches into his outing right now. That's the 1-2. Sets. Deals. That ball's going to be put on the play. Put in the play, but just foul. All down the third baseline. 1-2, you would assume you would be seeing a curveball here potentially after seeing about 2 straight fastballs right now.
Yeah, potentially.
But you never know. And again, St. Elizabeth right now could play a little bit of small ball here. Okay, so not necessarily looking for a sack bunt.
As curveball backdoors it in there for a strike. Mike, and that was a confident strikeout right there for Julian.
That was a little bit of a late call by the home plate umpire. But a much needed strikeout for Gonzalez just to get that first out.
Absolutely, especially
the third strikeout altogether for Keystone for their pitching staff.
Absolutely. Hey, Gravel going ahead, wrapping up two strikeouts for the Giants. And for right now, Edwards going to go ahead, pop that one in the air. Center field, Jason Thomas, long way to run, but makes up the ground. Oh, and then just like that, Julian, two outs here. Here, bottom. Top eight coming in.
Yeah, Thomas showing off that speed out in center field, able to get that pop out. Shallow center field, I would say. Much big second out for the Giants in the top of the eighth as Paul Hamilton is up at the dish.
Paul Hamilton, another guy, 1-for-3 as a little bit of an okie doke going out there.
Here you go, Jack.
As I said before, Hamilton 1-for-4 on the day with that single. Well, as Julian trying to get that curveball, but that time I'm ducked a little bit too much inside.
Here you go, Jake.
The 1-0. That ball's going to be cut on the ground. That's going to get through the left side. Like Kelly is going to fire on home. Oh, and they're going to go ahead. They're going to hold Otero over at third base. Ace and just like that, bases are now loaded for St. Elizabeth. Nathan, you're going to have
Zimmerman.
As you're going to have Drew Zimmerman now come up to bat.
I'm biased.
As I said before, bases loaded, two outs. If you're Julian right here, you need to find a way to get this third out.
Thank you.
Giving up no runs, better than giving up some runs.
Okay.
That's first pitch.
Thank you very much.
It's curveball in the dirt. 1-0. Maybe like 30 years old, Preston. I should be excited. Just at about 2 hours and 15 minutes here for game time through 8 innings. His next pitch is going to be a ball. All right down below. Oh, 2-0. Julian's just got to try and fire fastballs in here. Or you can't be getting too fancy with this. It's especially with the bases loaded. And something you would have to assume. If he loses a mirror, this could be the end of the road for Julian. As next pitch, fastball in the dirt, 3-0 count. Oh, and you would have to assume, unless this is a fastball, right down the middle. Oh, Zimmerman's taken all the way. Hey, you gotta hear strike three here. Or you gotta hear strike one here, excuse me. The 3-1. Fastball right down the middle. Oh, and as I said before, Zimmerman was taken all the way right there. The 3-1. God, on a miss, 3-2. Ooh, Julian throwing a little bit of a, almost like a little bit of a cutter. Wasn't necessarily a fastball, but also wasn't a little bit of a slider. More of a cutter right there. Threw it down in the zone. Boom, got Zimmerman to take the chase. Now he's got the big lefty. He on the ropes here. 3-2. Runners will be taking off. His next pitch is going to be foul off here. Otero over at third base did not necessarily take off with the pitch and everything like that. He's got to start. Granted, he is over at third base, but you got to take off with that pitch no matter what. Because the other thing that potentially could happen, running from second base takes off over a live shoot, that's an out. So I got to do a little bit of baseball awareness here. All right, next pitch is going to be a slider caught on and missed. It's in Julian tightrope out of danger once again. And St. Elizabeth leaves the bases loaded.
7.5.
And we go bottom eight.
Four remain. Giants 14. Eagles 4.
Let's see.
a 32. Let's see it. Oh, still has.
And then he's got his tall brother over here. The storm.
Listen,
right,
you know
there,
why? At least they're having fun.
And then behind him, we got the man with the, whatever you call that thing.
I'm still watching you. Don't think I'm not.
They're all wearing their beautiful straw hats. And they're not going to go.
Yeah, I know.
Leading off for the Giants,
get out.
Number 15. Excuse me, third baseman, number 14, Chris Hatzell.
Yeah.
Bottom of the eighth, Hatzell leading off for Keystone as they look to tack on their 10-run lead.
15 for 13, 11 for 14.
Yeah. 15-13.
First offering, fastball low in the dirt for ball one.
Here you go, Chris.
A couple changes to tell you about real quick for St. Elizabeth. Yeah, number five.
Who's the catching change?
Five.
Catching's going to be number 15.
Okay.
Oh, my God. Bring back Mondo, please.
We got a couple of changes to tell you about for St. Elizabeth. Yeah, over in left field is going to be number five, Ray Orta. Another senior out of Bound Brook, New Jersey. Yeah, and now catching for St. Elizabeth is going to be number 15, Anthony Padilla out of Cliffside, New Jersey. He's junior.
Oh, is that your first one? Oh, my God, he can't catch either.
As Rodriguez is going to go, he's going to fire strike in there as Hatzell is still out of here. 2-1 on the count.
Here you go, Chris.
Hatzell 1-for-3 on the day with an RBI.
That's the 2-1 gonna get by the catcher.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? Now playing left field for the Eagles, number 5, Ray Orta. Now catching for the Eagles, number 15, Anthony Padilla.
Oh. Hatzell's ahead of your 3-1. As Colin said before, Hatzell doing very well today so far. Or 1-for-3 on the day. As Hatzell's gonna go ahead, he's gonna draw a ball four right there, and that's gonna go ahead. That's gonna bring up Pedro Abreu.
They shouldn't let anybody be pitchers, huh?
Now batting the first baseman.
One thing I do want to keep.
Number 30, Pedro Abreu.
Yeah, Pedro.
And Pedro been one of the many spark. The other thing to keep in mind with Pedro. Oh, to acknowledge with them. 2-for-3 on the day for Pedro. Oh, as first pitch curveball is going to miss. Pedro 2-for-3. He's got a hit by pitch. He's got a 5-3 ground out, but he's got two singles to show for. And the other thing to keep in mind, Pedro's also scored, or both times he's got a single, so.
Eric Schubert was here yesterday.
Really?
Yeah.
He didn't come over and say hello to me.
He knew you were here, but he got a phone call.
Best
like,
ball high.
He didn't even say
by 2-0. Rodriguez having a hard time finding the strike zone here for a little bit.
I thought he was coming over, but then he got a call and he just made his way out.
And for what?
You got Kennedy Ferguson and for St. Elizabeth jogging down to the bullpen right now. Oh, as next pitch is going to be a ball right here. 3-0 to Pedro. Oh, and this is, and if you're St. Elizabeth right now, you got to throw up a little bit of a concern a little bit. It because, again, again, as next pitch, outside ball, ball, and just like that, back-to-back walks. Walks, as I believe we're going to be having a pitching change come in.
Yeah, number six, shut up the fucking switch.
Are they putting in Ferguson right away?
That looks like the
potentially, because he just got down to the bullpen.
Actually, I believe
and started throwing. And what they're doing, just a kind of little bit of quick toss, just so they have time.
I believe Ferguson's also being checked on by the St. Elizabeth trainer.
No numbers.
Or as yeah, it looks like we are
Rodriguez.
Gonna, yeah, as we are, looks like we are going to be getting a. So it looks like we are going to be getting a pitching change as Kennedy Ferguson, the freshman out of South Plainfield, New Jersey, he coming in.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Now pitching for the Eagles, number 26, Kennedy Ferguson. Oh.
I know the kid too. Let him have it.
To the hustler, killers, murderers, drug killers.
I'm gonna get some questions.
As mentioned before, we went to the break, pitching change for the Eagles. Kennedy Ferguson now in for the Eagles with on the season. The freshman has a 13.03 ERA. He's 1-1 on the year with 9 appearances and 1 start. Has pitched 9 2/3 innings with 5 strikeouts against 13 walks.
Yeah, Kennedy, as you said before, Kennedy Ferguson in a freshman out of South Plainfield, New Jersey.
I happen to know a little bit about
South Plainfield, New Jersey myself.
I was going to say, when you said that from South Plainfield, New Jersey, that was probably the most excited I heard anyone said that hometown.
Rarely get something like that, but the one thing I will say about South Plainfield pitchers is as first pitch is going to be ripped on the ground to first base. He stove over as Hamilton's going to go ahead. He's going to dive and make the tag, and that was a 5U fielder's choice.
Now batting, center fielder number 5, Jason Thomas.
Big fielders.
Because again, that was a fielder's choice, and again, normally you go against that and everything like that with the coming home with it and everything. But. Not too much. His next pitch from Ferguson in his high 1-0. That's the 1-0.
Hey, yo, what?
This next pitch is going to be a 2-0. Next pitch from Ferguson. Fastball inside, 3-0 as Ferguson trying to have a hard time finding the zone here.
Send the front one, please. Take a hit.
Next pitch. Fastball, JT just trying to take a look at that one. Ferguson coming in, firing mostly balls and everything like that. You got to take a ball right there. Once you hear strike one, then you can start worrying. Next pitch. That's going to be a ball 3-2. Ooh, JT was convinced that that was a ball, that that was ball four right
so
there.
So confident, he saw him toss the bat, getting ready to take off the batting gloves. Then umpire said, nope, that's strike two.
He said, come on back. That gets the 3-2.
Yep, that's a walk.
Ball low. Oh, so JT eventually does get his walk. Fuck, and a little bit of danger coming in as you go back to the top of the order here with JD Barrett.
Number 20, JD Barrett. Let's go, JD.
JD Barrett's going to go out. He's going to dig in for the Giants. It's JD 1-for-5 on the day. Or 2-for-5, excuse me, on the day. He's so far. Or JD's got two double. He's got a double on the day, a single, and he's got four RBIs. Ice for the Giants. As that ball is going to be hit a mile in the air, popped in the air, behind home plate. Catcher, or goes ahead. And as again, new catcher in the game. Anthony Padilla goes ahead, takes charge, catches it. That's going to go out. That's going to bring up Julio Acosta. But now. So Leo's going to dig in. You got RJ going to be coming on deck. First pitch, ball. Ball high. That's the 1-0. Fastball high as Ferguson misses.
Come on, Julio, getting sturdy. Okay, I see you.
My ball, Julio.
Hit the backspin, drop, one hand, hit up.
Yeah.
Wouldn't mind
a
oh, it's finished,
all right. RJ, neither would I. 3-0. Oh, is Ferguson having a hard time finding the zone here? You do not want to load the bases for this guy. 3-2 and a, or 3-1 and again. And same scenario. Oh, Ferguson coming in. And that's the thing. And that the Giants got to take advantage of on this one. But Ferguson came in cold. Didn't necessarily get that much of a warm-up. As Julio's going to go ahead and take ball four. Or as that's going to actually force in a run as Pedro was actually on third.
Was it enjoyable? The weather's pretty nice.
Now batting the catcher, number 22, R.J. Goolsbee! Yeah!
As I said before, bases loaded, walk goes ahead. That's going to bring in.
Get a grand slam and make it an easy 20-4. 20-4, I like that.
As that's going to be popped in the air, back over here.
Right here, right here.
Ow!
RJ just missing that one.
Give it back.
That's not just any ball.
Been a while since we've had a home run here. As we are looking. 15-4. 15-4, bottom eight. RJ behind in the count, 1-0-1. Next pitch from Ferguson. Fastball high, 1-1. I would assume the one guy you don't want to see this get back to the bottom of the order or get back another chance to bat would be Adam Kelly. He would assume simply because of the fact he's due up second in this inning. As RJ's going to pop that in the air, swung out of his shoes on that one. It's going to be popped in the air behind home plate. Ferguson working ahead here, 1-2. This is the next pitch. Curveball in the dirt. Ferguson trying to get RJ to chase right there, but RJ, great job showing the discipline right there. Next pitch to RJ. That ball is hit in the air. Left field. That is high. It is far, but it is caught at the wall. Oh, but Giants get one, but Strand, the base is loaded. And we go top nine here. We might be seeing a pitching change come from the Giants, but like I said before, we go top nine.
Like on their asses, like all
at the end of eight innings.
We can't yell that every day.
Your score now, the Giants.
You good, RJ? You good, baby? What's the time of the game?
Eagles 4.
Giants 3 outs away as we got a new, as we got two more changes to tell you about for the Giants. Now in right field for the Giants is going to go ahead. It's going to be number 4, Devin Reed. And the Giants, it's as Ross working quickly and kind of just spoiler right there. Here, now pitching for the Giants, number 55, Ross Zanghi. And Ross working quickly, the 0-1 just misses. Ross on the season, 5.73 ERA, a 6 appearances, 1 start. As that's going to go ahead, that's going to be ripped into right into center field. That's going to get over Jason's head, and that's going to roll to the wall. Oh. Padilla's going to go ahead. He's going to cruise into second base with a double, and just like that, at St. Elizabeth, starting off the top of the ninth.
Now batting the shortstop, number 12, Jack Tone.
As I was saying before, for Ross with a 5.73 ERA, 6 starts. Or 6 appearances, 1 start, 11 innings pitched, 8 hits, 10 runs, 7 of them earned, 12 walks to 16 strikeouts as Ross's next pitch is a ball low fastball. All from Zanghi. Ross the senior out of Scranton, Pennsylvania, as he fires in a strike right there.
Come on, Ross, pick it up.
This is going to be a 2-1 from Ross. Ross actually did get a chance to pitch against St. Elizabeth in the regular season. And I believe. My apologies, I read the wrong sheet. Ross actually pitched in the CSAC this season and had one appearance, but no earned runs. Isn't that something? 3-2 from Ross. Ross is fired in for a strike. Ross comes set to 3-2. Popped in the air. Right at second base. Ace and right field, but Devin Reed calls off J.D. Barrett, and just like that, Giants, two outs away. A from advancing.
Start packing, buddy.
Now batting the right fielder, number 4, Joe Brown.
You gotta go ahead, you gotta have Joe Brown dig into the bat. Wrong. 2 for 4 on the day. He's so far with a walk and again, can't stress this enough. Brong also hit that solo home run back in the top of the first. First to lead off the game as the 1-0 from Ross. Slider in there for a strike and just like that, 1-1 from Ross. Ross working quickly here. Here is next pitch. It's going to be fouled off, and just like that, Ross doing a great job getting ahead here.
Yeah, Zanke's working ahead. He's working quick. He's trying to kind of push the pace a little bit, trying to end this game.
Ross is trying to send Enke still onto the finals that will put them in against Wilson on Friday. It will be game one as the 1-2. Fastball high. High Brong had to do a little bit of limbo right there just to get out of the way. As Ross with the 2-2. That pitch is going to be swung on, popped in the air. Her right side once again, Devin Reed camps underneath it, makes the catch. Catching just like that, Giants one out away. Hey, as that's going to go ahead, Padilla is going to stay on second base. Ace, and the last hope for St. Elizabeth is going to be the second baseman, number 14.
Number 14, Justin Otero.
Justin Otero.
Damn, that traffic on the way back was crazy, man.
Notice how when Reed checked into the game, all the outs have been towards him.
Oh, absolutely.
Baseball finds a new man.
Reed is a flyout help magnet out there.
A specimen in the outfield.
Absolutely. This Ross is going to go ahead and step off real quick, try and get the signs from RJ. This first pitch, that's going to be roped into left field. That's going to drop right in front of Matt and Kelly. They're going to go ahead. They're going to send Padilla home. Hatzel. Catches the relay. And just like that, at St. Elizabeth, he's showing a little bit of life. Down one now, 15-5.
Now batting the center fielder, number 22, Jake Pipperstick.
Just grab all your stuff. Let's go, Rob.
That's going to go ahead. That's going to bring up Jake Pipperstick. Yeah, cool. Well, last game, again, had the 2 home runs, but this game has been relatively quiet.
Here you go, Ross.
0-3 with 2 walks today so far.
Come on, baby. Come on.
That's first pitch fastball. Ball is going to be in there, or is going to be taken for a ball, but because of defensive indifference, Otero goes ahead, takes second on that one. As that's going to be chopped foul. Oh, as just like that, at St. Elizabeth. It's going to be a 1-1 run count.
Send it home, please! Come on!
Zengi with his 17th pitch incoming here as Piprick is going to go ahead. He's going to step out.
It's just one. Yeah, one strike on the count, right? It's 1-1.
Oh, what's the count off?
Oh, it's an 0-2 count.
Here we go, Ross. Here we go.
Yeah. 0-2 count. So, Keystone is actually one out away. His next pitch. That's going to be popped in the air. Right field. Devin Reed camps underneath it. And just like that, the Giants are going to be advancing. And on Friday, they to face Wilson. 1-2. And Mr. Franco, that is something we have said before plenty of times. Times as
Giants
as
16.
Can you smell rematch, good sir?
Yeah, it's a rematch of last year's CSAC title game. It's gonna be a really competitive series, both teams.
I'm not sure about the time, but I'll tell you this: we're scheduled to have.
But I tell you what, this is a big bounce back win for Keystone after a really rough game two.
Absolutely.
There's some things that they need to work on, but a good win for them overall.
Absolutely, absolutely. And again, the thing to keep in mind, fine with this St. Elizabeth. Again, the thing to keep in mind, Giants got to work on what they needed to get to work, fixed everything, came back 15-5. Five, as we said, games should be at 3 o'clock on Wednesday, on Friday. Keep checking the website. However, we will be on the call for Friday, paying everything like that.
And so,
oh, nonetheless, championship series does come back to Keystone, and we say this many times.
Have a great evening.
Championship road comes through Factoryville. Oh, we'll be on the call for Friday. Hey, Mr. Franco, final thoughts on the game.
I just mean a competitive series are on. I got to give credit to St. Elizabeth, too. You know, they played a phenomenal series. I mean, they have nothing to be ashamed about. And Grant, I know they're upset that they lost because their season's now done, but they have a lot to be proud of. First playoff appearance, CSEC semifinals. I've been forcing a game three on Keystone, which no other team in the CSEC has done that for a while in the semifinals. But I mean, they have a lot to be proud of this season. And for Keystone as well, another trip to the conference championship, looking to add on to their accolades on the left field wall, but overall, just a very good series, and we'll definitely be looking forward to Friday.
Absolutely, and again, first pitches should be scheduled for 3 o'clock. If it is not scheduled for 3 o'clock, make sure you keep checking the website. Make sure you keep checking the website and the newspaper, everything of your social. Oh, we will be live 15 minutes before first pitch with a little bit of a pregame. Hey, nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, for Colin Franco, I've been JT Colapietro. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great rest of the night. Enjoy the rest of the week, and we will see you on Friday. You